Start the timer.
Oh, okay. Now YouTube.
You just tweeted about space dogs.
Yeah, poor dogs.
That makes me super sad. Moving on.
It says I'm not getting data from my encoder, but it also says I'm live. No, it says it's all right now.
Okay.
Oh, now I gotta go on that.
Oh shit, my phone's across the room from me.
Oh man. Oh, we don't want that. Okay, pause that. I gotta shut a whole bunch of stuff down now.
Okay.
Am I hearing this now?
So I'm turning. Okay, so I got the video, and we're a minute behind ourselves, so I'm turning that off.
Oi, okay. This is tough, getting all this. I got two computers going. What's that?
You don't have Chad.
No, you know, I have transcended Chad at this point.
No, you haven't. You miss Chad.
No, I really need Chad. But this makes it really simple, right? Because it's just you and it's just me.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to change the camera. I'm really not even going to... I'm going to drink some beer and I'm going to watch this movie and just try to get through it.
Hello, everyone! Welcome! Do you want to do... Do we do an official intro or what are we doing?
What do you mean? An intro? This... masterpiece speaks for itself.
We're doing it live. Do it live.
Yeah. So okay. Yeah. So if you have no idea what's going on here, and I don't surprise you because this is pretty weird what we're about to do. We're gonna watch Armageddon together, Nicole and I, and you're gonna watch it with us. So what you need to do is you need to go to Netflix. Or you need to go to Google Play, or you need to grab that old DVD that you bought in shame, and you need to put it in the DVD player and put it on, and then figure out a way that you can then get the audio from Nicole and I into your
brain
ear holes.
Your ear balls.
Yeah, and then we will consume tasty beverages, we will watch this movie, and we will attempt to endure the science. And perhaps, you know, we might, I don't know, have a few comments here and there. I don't know. It's a long movie. This is like going to be mini bathroom breaks, I think. You know, it's going to be a tough one.
Well, that's why I'm glad there's two of us. So, hi, everybody. I'm Nicole, Noisy Astronomer. And Fraser has, I agreed to do this for a fundraiser, and Fraser has graciously allowed us to use his channel and has set up the fancy Zoom with the countdown and all of that good stuff for us. So this is for the DIY Science Zone fundraiser for Geek Girl Con, which is in less than a week now. It's October 8th and 9th in Seattle. We are trying to raise a total of $6,000 to pay for several of us to do a whole bunch of hands-on science experiments over the 2 days of the con. This has been running for a few years now. The director is Dr. Rachel Burks, who is a chemist and a professor. And she's asked us all to do acts of Whimsy as our thank you to you for donating. This was for the $4,500 level of our $6,000 fundraiser. We've got less than a week to go to close that up. So we've got the link in the description below. I'll post the link in the chat for those of you watching as well. So feel free to share the link. Throw us a few bucks. It helps kids do science at this crazy awesome event in Seattle. And there will be more acts of whimsy to come if we reach the $5,750 level before, you know, heading out. I will teach one of my classes. I'm a professor in New Hampshire. I will teach one of my classes as Holtzman from Ghostbusters, full outfit, full right costume. On. The goggles and everything. So there's a bunch of fun.
Oh, yeah. Activities. Like, it's like a big problem for you. You do this like at the drop of a hat. You do this just, you know, for fun.
I do wear the goggles a lot. I've not come to class in cosplay.
Yeah.
At least outside of Halloween. So, but yeah, there's a couple of other people who have done. Tori, one of our scientists, is also has taught one of her classes in a Harry Potter costume. Gwen Pearson is at an entomology conference right now. She went around the conference one day in a bee costume, one of her professional science conferences in a bee costume. So there's a lot of fun things happening right now with this fundraiser.
So a bunch of people are asking, like, what's going on? What is this? So just to got to be clear here, we are going to watch the movie Armageddon, you know, the one with Ben Affleck and the bald guy.
The bald guy.
You know,
don't diss Bruce Willis.
Yeah, done. Directed by the explosions guy, and and then we're gonna talk about the science. We're gonna talk about just the movie. We're just gonna hang out with you guys. And so, you need to get a copy of the movie in front of you. And the easiest way to do that is Netflix. Yeah, it's an old movie. Sheila Francie wants to know. It is on Netflix, so if you've got a Netflix account, it's right there. I've got it queued up here in Canada, so I'm assuming it's in the U.S. because you guys get everything. You're watching on your U.S. Netflix?
Yes, it is on my U.S. Netflix.
And then, so come on, Paul Stewart, it's got to be in New Zealand
Paul.
Netflix too. Or you can get a copy from Google Play, you can get a copy from iTunes, you can get a copy from Amazon. I'm sure you've purchased a copy already. So just, we've got the countdown timer up there. And then when we get to the bottom of that, so the intro part is over, we will then start up the timer and at the exact same time that we then are both watching the movie. And so then
now remember, I can't see the timer. So you got to give me a countdown, an audible countdown.
Yeah. I'll say, you know, 3, 2, 1, go. Yeah. And we'll watch it. So I've got it right now on my Netflix queued up at, you know, it now says 2:31:10 to go. And there's like the beginning of the blue little bar there. So that's where it's going to start. Yeah, this is the 1998 movie starring the bald guy,
the handsome guy,
the elf girl.
Doesn't she like look more natural when she has pointy ears? I feel like Liv Tyler should always have pointy ears. She looks beautiful as an elf.
You don't have Netflix in Australia? No.
Oh,
yeah, you do.
Kinda.
What?
Well, this was one that I know we own, so I would have watched it there anyway with our copy.
Yeah, totally have Netflix in Australia. Netflix.com/AU.
And I would say someone's having not enough time to download. If you want to start the download now and join us, since the timestamp of where we are will be running above us, you could skip ahead to where we are.
Yeah, you can just catch up with us whenever you get to to that point.
Yeah.
If you just want to comment, D Jones, you've commented it on it. So go ahead. Galaxia, I do not recommend piracy. You should get a legitimate copy of this movie. No, Nicole, a legitimate copy of this movie to support the hard work and creativity that went into it. So that's important.
Don't be shaming the viewers, man.
Since I'm dropping a bunch of frames. I wonder why.
Although I think I already cursed when I lost my phone, I promise to try and keep this somewhat clean since this isn't my channel.
Good luck.
I am drinking, I'm drinking a bottle of wine that I started for the presidential debate on Monday.
Mm-hmm.
This is a gift from one of my coworkers. We let him crash at our house before a long drive for a geology trip. This is Lucky Duck Moscato, so I'm finishing that off. I feel like I should show people. I will be eating a pint of Häagen-Dazs because I have no self-control. It'll be great.
Birdshot1902 is wondering if we could just play it on the screen? Absolutely not. That would be a deep, dark copyright infringement, and there's no way that I would ever display that on this channel. That would be crazy. We would be sued by morning time. So no, there will be no content that comes from this show making it into it. Man, why is the stream going down?
Poke. I missed the last Weekly Space Hangout. I was at a workshop, but one before that, you had some problems.
Yeah, I see some dropped frames. I got to figure out why the dropped frames are dropping. I can try downgrade. I've got such a fast internet connection though, so there really should be no reason why I'm dropping frames. I'm gonna make sure I've got everything gone off my computer.
Yes, Kurt, this will be like MSG3K, except you won't see the movie. So it's more like Riff Tracks, which is the same people who did MSG3K, where they give out the audio of their commentary, and you play that the same time you play the movie. I'll host this up on my channel afterwards so that you can relive the fun, not live, if you want to. Why not?
All right, so I got I've dropped every background task that could possibly happen, and let's hope that that improves things. He chose cold temperature in North Dakota. He was saying it was like minus 60 in North Dakota with the wind chill.
Jeez,
that is not right. So what are you drinking?
I am drinking a Lucky Duck Moscato.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, one of my lovely coworkers crashed here one night because he had to take a whole bunch of students on a field trip to Mount Washington, and it was going to save him like 3 hours of driving to leave from here as opposed to his house, so in Maine. So he stayed over. Tim came home, and I was working on physics. It was Friday night. I'm working on physics problems. My colleague is sorting through rocks for a geology lab. He's like, wow, you guys are so excited. It's like, can we apply? So yeah, thank you, Ian. Put the link for the Psy Zone on Twitter one more time.
I'm going to turn off my real-time protection in Windows 10. That's probably it.
Oh, I don't know what this means because I don't understand.
In Windows? You don't understand Windows?
No, I really don't. My students will come to me because I throw all kinds of physics Java apps at them and stuff for their homework, and they're like, hey, can you help me download it? I'm like, is it Windows? I can poke at it. If it's Mac, I can help you. If it's not, I don't know what's happening.
No, we are not going to post the movie. We are not going to post the movie. We are only going to...
It's on Netflix, and it's on all the places. Well, it's not on everyone. I think Citizen Gold also pointed out it is not on New Zealand Netflix. Very sad.
Oh, it's not on New Zealand Netflix?
Yeah.
Well, this will be available later on, so you can
relive the horror.
You can, relive the horror.
I did drunkenly watch 2012 once, not on the internet, just with my friends, and oh my god, I entertained myself at least.
Okay, do you want to know a dark secret?
Don't tell me you like that movie.
I like that movie.
Oh, that
movie. I liked it.
Good for a disaster movie,
but there was like watching all of that stuff get exploded was just
but
super
it was
fun.
The Yellowstone scene was pretty cool, but like they drive through a white picket fence and it's clearly a CGI white picket fence. Like, at least destroy a real white picket fence for me.
Fences are expensive and complicated, so
I don't want to hear it. Hollywood is money.
All right, so I just,
thank you, Jim.
All right, so I guess, I wonder how people are going to do this, because they're going to have to, well, it'll work, it should work, I think this will work.
Even though they're on a delay from us, they'll still hear us at the same time. It's just the text commentary in the chat that's going to...
That's right, and so as long as I keep this timer running, what is right for me and you,
right.
then work. That'll work for them.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's just the chat. I think if we're trying to use the chat, that'll be behind
Yeah. 3, 2, 1.
Wait,
down. Are you
getting...
Beep, 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 beep. I don't know if you're getting the beep, beep, beep. Okay.
No, am I supposed to press play now?
No, no, wait, wait, wait a second. Wait a second. Whatever you do, don't press play.
I have the little blue thing.
Oh, I need a timer now, right? All right. So let's see. I need a stopwatch, and then I can start it, right?
I don't know.
Okay. Here we go. So
Just tell me when to press play.
Okay. I'm gonna go 3, 2, 1. Press play. Okay. Okay. Ready?
Wait. That wasn't it.
No, that wasn't it. Okay. Ready?
I haven't had any wine yet.
Oh.
Okay. This is just
okay. 3, 2, 1. You ready?
Yes.
Okay. All right.
Am I pressing it now?
Yeah. Oh, sorry. Oh, okay, hold on. I said I was going to be 3, 2, 1, and then I didn't even 3, 2, 1. Hold on. I go back
to
the beginning.
Go back.
I'm back. All right. This is not a good start for us. Okay. I'm going to go. Okay, you ready? Three. Yeah. Two, one, start.
Go.
All right.
There's my blue touchdown thing. Wow, we're really bad at this.
Yeah, we really did a bad job of that. All right, so I'm seeing the lightning and a roadway. Is that you seeing that as well? Okay.
Like we're probably pretty close.
All right.
I wonder if there's a way I think I can make the movie a little lower so I can hear you. Because I know I've seen this. So... to be fair, this movie came out in 98.
Yeah.
I was 14. I thought it was great. I didn't know a whole lot of science at 14. I didn't know how bad the science was.
Yeah.
And Ben Affleck's cute, so.
Oh, when you said this, like, I was like, oh, this is a great idea. I'd love to do this. And now I have to give myself, like, this is good. I have to endure this now.
Yes, you do.
What was I getting into?
Who's doing the voiceover?
It's great. It's like the best part of the whole movie is this little science bit.
Science.
Yeah.
It kind of looks like Rosetta. Oh, no, that's not it. You know what? It kind of looks a little bit like Rosetta's Comet.
Oh, it's Charlton Heston, by the way, did that voiceover.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, Charlton Heston, why? Fun fact. That impact probably didn't single-handedly kill the dinosaurs.
What was that and the volcanoes afterwards?
It wasn't. There was like other stuff that had already been going on. I don't remember the real science, but astronomers love to talk about how this asteroid wiped out the dinosaurs, but it's like it had a part. It wasn't a huge part.
Yeah. Muhammad wants to know: are you supposed to watch our reactions to the entire length of the movie? No, you're supposed to watch the movie with us and then react as well, and laugh knowingly at to what we're seeing.
Armageddon.
No, we can't give you any audio. So I'll get a copyright flag.
We don't want to get taken down.
Yep.
This is like riff tracks, you guys.
Yeah. I'm going to put closed captions on mine.
Oh, 65 million years later.
Yeah.
Also, I never remember actors' names, although apparently you don't even know who Bruce Willis is, so.
Yeah. The bald guy. All right. So this is great. This is like that opening scene from Gravity, right? But like a prototype version of it.
Why is the cockpit so dark? Did they like not afford lights in the shuttle in the 90s?
Well, which is it? Are they in the sun or are they in the shade? This is the most dangerous spacewalk.
Who let me ever. Bob Thornton?
The guy's been, you know, this astronaut has been training. They've trained for literally years to do this. Every single maneuver, every single move.
It's choreographed.
It's completely choreographed. You know, they've done this literally 100 times in water tanks with problems.
Look at the cockpit. It's so dark.
Oh, someone said the countdown to Armageddon is going up. Should I change it? Okay, hold on. I got to change that now.
It should go up. Oh,
well, it should, What?
He's dying.
Oh. Sorry, I was changing text. I didn't even see that part. There you go. Countdown from Armageddon. There.
Nobody saw it coming. No one saw it coming.
Yeah. I mean, the level of aim from these asteroids, like the chances of them. Okay, keep in mind, right? The space shuttle's moving at 28,000 kilometers per hour around the Earth, and it intersects asteroid chunks coming in. Yeah, touchdown. Man, the only thing that would be more amazing would it for these chunks of space rock to hit major U.S. landmarks.
Wouldn't that be weird?
Yeah.
Here it goes. I think this is the same. No, it was a year after Independence Day, but it looked like the same scene. We're all getting in the cockpits.
Yeah. Well, how many times has New York or the Golden Gate Bridge just taken it on the chin?
Oh, no. Does this one? Oh, no. I just had a realization. Does this have the Twin Towers go down? Because that was.
No, it doesn't. Okay, but it was. But the Twin Towers are in it, but it's before.
Okay. Yeah. I know. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
I don't, this is props to all the astronomers out there. This is what we look like.
Is this what it's like? It looks like something's burning up there. Hold on, let me
our
just.
Our wives want to divorce us.
Just like looking through a telescope. Hold on. Like most astronomers are sometimes not even in the same continent as their telescope. Someone says I look tanned as AF.
Well, I think the idea is he's an amateur astronomer. So, you know,
yeah.
You look through telescopes, you're an amateur astronomer.
Yeah.
But most significant others are a bit more supportive than that, I think.
Yeah. no spoiler, please, no.
Yeah, well. Yeah. Oh, sorry. We just had the anniversary. I'm not,
What, seeing the Twin Towers in New York City?
The Twin Towers is still looking for me.
Yeah.
Oh my God, the dog!
Why am I orange? Probably because I have bad white balance. And also, I just came back from Florida, and I've just had alcohol. So, that whenever I drink alcohol, it makes my face go flush red right away.
I forgot the entire soundtrack is by
Aerosmith. It's by Aerosmith. Yeah. Yeah.
Somebody pointed out. Wait, I just saw a thing. I'm sorry, Nathan. Nathan said his wife does want a divorce all the time because of this thing. Oh, your channel blacklist is not letting them curse, Fraser.
Yeah, I know. You can't curse.
That's
sad. Got to keep it clean. I don't have many words. Oh, now keep in mind that this just came out. This movie came out just before Godzilla. Stop. Right. So okay. I think this was them sticking the boots to Godzilla. What did I think of the core? Oh.
Yes, we should do the core. It's so bad.
Yeah. Sunshine.
I dated a guy who thought that movie was great in college, and that should have been a warning sign.
Really?
Yes. He thought it was a great science movie. Yeah, always New York, man. Like, the globe is this big full of water, and it's always
New York. Well, exactly. Well, you know, first, taking out the space shuttle, and second, taking out New York City, major landmarks.
Yeah.
But you need to go into, you know, you need something that's gonna bring everyone into it. Oh. Oh, poor dog.
The dog is not allowed to die. The dog can never die. Look at that dog. The dog's just like, save me.
My screen is full. Bogies are breaching.
Oh, there's the VLA for no reason.
Was that the VLA?
I have no idea.
Oh, okay.
How many other linear arrays of telescopes are there? They're all radio astronomy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Boom.
There goes New York again.
So how does this compare to what would actually happen with... well, I guess the point is they wouldn't come in like we saw with Chelyabinsk, right? They're not going to come in like... streaking fire. They're just going to detonate in the atmosphere and cause explosions. So, I mean, now we've seen Chelyabinsk, so we'll know what would happen.
And they're probably going to come in... Well, no, that one's coming in at a low angle. Well, they're coming in from all different angles. That's the other thing.
Yeah.
Like, where are they... They're just coming from every direction.
Yeah.
Also, New Yorkers would totally handle that way better. Just saying.
Yeah. You see, so what I liked about this movie, and there isn't very much, but I like this. Like, by all means, blow up New York City. Like, that's
Why you gotta do it to me? Why you gotta do this to me?
Like 2012, like tear apart Los Angeles and the whole Yellowstone thing. Like, you know, I'm fine with a tremendous amount of destruction.
Still took down cities that don't normally get destroyed. Yeah, see, it hits the tower. I don't like that scene.
Yeah. And the timing's pretty bad, right? This is 1998.
This is 98.
Yeah.
This is before.
Yeah.
But Phil took down Sydney in his Bad Universe series because he's like, they always do New York. Let's take out Sydney.
They always do the Golden Gate Bridge. Ryle Sands says, why is the countdown counting up? That is where we are in the movie. We are 9 minutes and 21 seconds into the movie.
So if you want to join us, that's the timestamp.
That's where we are, I think.
Something.
Mine doesn't show. Mine only shows me the count. Oh, no, it shows me. Okay. Yeah.
If you hover over it.
11,000 people at NASA. Isn't there more like 100,000 people at NASA?
And that, well, it depends on if you include the contractors.
Yeah, right. And how many people are actually working on it.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's true, right? Person who finds a comet or an asteroid gets to name it, right?
Yep.
Yeah. I want to get that Hubble moving. We're moving the Hubble. Well, there's the director right there. Did you see him?
No.
That was Michael Bay.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, Michael Bay. You've given us so much to make fun of.
Yeah.
What is that even? No!
What is that? There it is. What is that? It's like some kind of planetary nebula there? What is that? Yeah, that looks like a planetary nebula maybe, or like some food coloring in water.
Oh, well, there you go. It's an asteroid, sir.
Yeah.
Obviously.
Yeah. Oh.
It is a big S guy. That is correct.
Yes.
That's scientifically correct.
This is a real, this is truth. Yeah.
Truth bomb.
So that's a real thing, right? A global, a global killing asteroid, but that would be 10 kilometers and above. I mean, but not survive nothing, including bacteria. There's nothing that could kill all life on Earth, including bacteria.
I feel like microbes would be fine.
Yeah.
Like some extremophile somewhere would be like, what's up? It's just another day.
Yeah.
Oh, here comes the, here comes the dude.
Oh, we have 18 days. So, okay. So Nicole, now we watch this golf shot here. 18 days.
Yes.
So, an asteroid the size of Texas. Yes. How many of them are there that are out there?
One. Its name is Ceres.
That's it.
It was discovered in 1800 or 1801.
Right. So the only asteroids that is that big, you don't need an asteroid that is the size of Texas. There's one. You know, maybe Vesta if you want like a little bit smaller. You know, a 10-kilometer asteroid. Well, there's none that are unfound now.
Yeah, that's the idea. Unless it came from, outer solar system.
Yeah, like a comet, like Deep Impact. Like, that was a much more realistic.
Yeah, but if Taylor only didn't die, I don't want to see that movie because I'm in love with David Duchovny. Or at least I was in 1998.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, this is Bruce Willis, Fraser. That's his name. Bruce Willis.
Bruce Willis, yeah, the bald guy. The bald guy.
The bald guy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, in LaGrange, but I think it's an Aerosmith cover of LaGrange, which is ridiculous.
Yeah.
Oh, he's so cute.
Tardigrades. David Trogue says tardigrades
would totally survive.
They would. Yeah. In fact, the tardigrades are waiting for us to just make a mistake, and then they can take over.
Ooh, whoa, there's a dog. Macy wants in. Hi. Hi.
We should do a scary movie sometime.
Not disobey my rules.
This is all just like the human part.
Matriarchy. What?
I find this like human beings talking to each other boring.
I can tell.
Yeah.
But one of them's adorable. Actually, Bruce Willis is adorable.
Yeah.
Uh-oh, something's going on. I'm dripping ice cream on my mouse pad.
So would a comet the size of Texas destroy the Earth to the bacteria level? You need an object like the size of Mars.
I mean, you have to get, like, much of the crust molten. Like, okay, yeah, like an object the size of Mars.
Yeah, like, created, yeah, like Theia, right?
Pretty much sterilize everything.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. Hi, Harry.
Why is she on the oil rig?
She's his daughter. She's helping run the company.
Okay, all right.
There's a reason.
All right.
And she's also boinking the hot one.
So. I want every strategy we've got. Anything that'll let you stop an object the size of Texas that's only 18 days out. What have you got? Nothing?
A shotgun. A shotgun.
Yeah.
Obviously you have a shotgun.
Here, right here, Steve Buscemi in this movie. That is the greatest part of this entire movie, I think. He makes everything better.
Harry! Right. My daughter doesn't have bodily autonomy because I am manly man and I will get annoyed at anyone she boinks. Oh, you didn't know there'd be feminist commentary in addition to the science?
Whatever you need.
Thanks, dear.
Yeah.
Oh, I love him.
Who is
it? Look at that giant ass wrench.
Hmm.
I love Bear.
Man can work with one foot.
Billy Bob Thornton should read bedtime stories. I'm down with that.
I'm recording a copy of this locally to all the people that says it's streaming. So, and that version probably won't have all the drop frames. Maybe that's why it's dropping frames. I don't know.
In his boxers.
Is there some risk of shooting a shotgun on an oil rig with all the high pressure tanks and pipes and stuff? It's got to be, like, some kind of risk.
Yes, but somebody was bunking his little girl, so. Love of a crazy father, I guess.
Yeah.
Fuck around!
So who in the stream, who is actually watching this that actually is watching with us? I'd love to see some people who are actually doing it.
Oh, my feminism made people sad.
Oh, okay. Spread focus laser generator to heat it up to the point of fracture.
Nope. I have a laser pointer. Look at it. Oh, look, they have a little thing. Now, this would work if you had a lot more than 18 guns.
Yeah, if you had 18 days, both of those ideas are perfectly feasible. Shoot a laser at it, ablate some material off of it, reposition it. You attach a solar sail to it, use that
gravity
to push it away.
Of a spacecraft to, you know,
yeah.
Push it off course a little bit.
Yeah.
Especially if it's in pieces. A lot of these asteroids are not one solid piece.
Yeah.
Gravity, it's going to do a lot better than trying to blow it up.
Yeah. And so that's the problem, right? Is that 18 days, you're boned. There's nothing you can do to stop an asteroid from hitting you in 18 days.
Yes,
maybe
there is Bruce Willis.
If you've got 18 years, maybe. But 18 days, that's crazy.
Yeah.
Why do you have purple hair, Nicole?
Why do I have purple hair?
Yeah.
Because I like purple.
Birdshot 1902 is watching with us.
And I'm a professor that can get away with it, apparently.
Yeah. Yeah. Now that you're a PhD.
Yeah, that was a little iffy.
Yeah, you're a PhD. You can have any color hair you like.
Oh.
All right. Gina Rodkey is watching. D. Jones is watching with us. Yeah. So notice we talk when there's just like them wandering around on a oil rig, and then when the actual movie part is, you know, when the important science part is happening, then we're intrigued.
Important science. Also, because I've seen this movie a lot of times.
Really? I've only seen it once before this. Yeah.
I saw it in theaters when I was a kid. I saw it last time. One of the last times I saw it was in a theater full of astronomers at an astronomy conference, and there was beer and a buzzer. And it was fabulous.
That's hilarious.
Yeah, it was good.
So Galaxy is saying I've watched space documentaries. So the idea that I had, send up 150 nuclear warheads. Yeah. Now we're talking.
Speed is also, okay, somebody pointed out, speed is also a factor, not just the mass, and that is true as well. But I feel like the Mars-sized impact of when it hit Earth, it, like, made everything molten. that may not be entirely true, but it, like, re-moltenized the crust.
Yeah.
Oh, the British guy is the smart one, obviously, because of the accent. Ignore the science advisors, because I'm British.
C-minus astrophysics. What did you get in astrophysics? That's not one course. You don't just take astrophysics as one course.
I mean, if you do, you probably shouldn't be protecting the world against an asteroid. Your hand gets burned, stupid.
So.
This is a terrible metaphor. You really shouldn't have a prior cracker in your open hand either.
Right. Well, no, but you shouldn't do it either way. But the point is that you deep core driller. It's like you don't blow up the asteroid, because all you then do is have a whole bunch of chunks of asteroid, which are all still on the same trajectory. That no amount of exploding it up is going to protect you from the asteroid. You've got to redirect it. So the hitting 150 nuclear, the shooting the 150 nuclear warheads at it is a much better idea than attempting to dig a hole in it and put an asteroid, put a nuclear bomb inside and cracking it into pieces. So you really need to get it moved to a different location. So it's just
the whole thing.
Yeah. And so, I mean, this is, you know, when this movie came out, the thing that everyone who knew their science was talking about again and again and again was this, that's a terrible idea. I mean, all the other ideas are terrible, but because the premise is so bad, but nobody wants to see a movie where you got to wait,
terrible.
Got to wait 20 years to find out if your solution happens.
Can't we live in the hollow earth if this happens? Just live inside. Yeah, Lord.
Wherever
Dusty's
they said
it. Dusty's watching with us as well. I just saw. Yay, hi, Dusty.
Can't we just live in the Hollow Earth if this happened? Yeah. Yeah, we'll go to the Hollow Earth. Birdshot 19, do we do this every Saturday night? No, but maybe we should. I don't know. This is a lot of fun. But maybe that's my tasty stout beer talking.
I finished my ice cream. I'm so cliche right now. Get on the chopper, no questions asked.
Get on the chopper.
Get to the chopper. I like how, so the fact that they have invited him, not really invited him, but like, get on the goddamn chopper. Like, they've already figured out they've gone through all of their options.
Yeah. This guy can drill anything.
For like 3 hours, and they've gone through all their options.
Yeah. Gotta bring my daughter along. Oh, got her off the oil. Nicely done.
Can't have her boinking cute guy while he's gone.
NASA in Houston.
5 out of 5.
Is that the real NASA Space Johnson Space Center? I've never been I've never been to Houston.
Wrong.
Yeah.
I don't know. That font looks wrong. But I could be. I've never been, so.
I mean, there is a rocket on the ground in Houston like that. Okay, so the rogue comet hit the asteroid belt.
Still, we would have seen it more than 18 days out.
Yeah, well, yeah.
Theories coming at us from the outer
space. So this is legit. That if an asteroid hits the ocean, it's as bad or worse than if it hits land.
Oh. Where am I at now, Nicole? I am in New Hampshire. Woo!
Yeah.
Yes, that's a terrible Schwarzenegger impression. I fully take the blame. The guy who can drill anything and the guy who drilled his dog. No.
There was I just finished reading Seven Eves, which is a great sort of tackling of a similar event, and the response to it is great.
I need to read that book. Several people have been like, you need to read that book.
Yeah.
Oh, and I love, they showed a little bit, but this asteroid is not just an asteroid. It's like a Seussian nightmare.
Of an asteroid?
Yes.
Yeah. And it's funny that nobody else has seen it. Like,
yeah, it's top secret.
A major city got demolished by asteroids, and so people were looking for more. You know, people would be looking for more asteroids. Because you're the best.
This is the part where Ben Affleck's commentary in the DVD.
Yeah, I know. I listened to that before we did that. It was so good. Emma wants to know why it's worse if it hits the ocean. Because it creates this enormous tidal wave that ruins all the coastal cities all around it. So it's tsunamis, but the wave is 1,000 feet high. Patents don't apply to outer space. We built this drill and we don't know how it works.
But we were going to send it to Mars.
So we're going to send it to space. Oh, wrong cams. Write that down, NASA idiots. So why have they been training for 8 months?
To go to Mars, apparently.
Uh, 22,000 kilometers per hour. That's not bad. That's pretty fast.
What is that?
22,000 kilometers per hour?
What is that in Mercury units? Like 30?
Well, it's like, I mean, orbital velocity is like 8 kilometers per second. And that's 28,000 kilometers per hour.
Astronauts don't know anything. They're just nerds. Oh my God. Yes, this is a Michael Bay movie.
Yeah.
What's the dog one? Boy Scouts. You know, I feel bad for any astronaut watching this movie.
Or anyone working in NASA.
Anyone right? Working for anything.
They have hundreds of astronauts at any time.
Down with the elitism. Down with the intellectual elite.
Well, there's a little bit of space walking crazy astronaut stuff.
No space walking. No, it's fine. You're just drilling.
Is the space patent comment true? No. No, but then, you know, enforcement is 9/10 of the rule. So if, you know, someone takes your drill to space and starts drilling on asteroids and you want to stop them, you've got to go get them. Yeah. Does it have enough reaction wheels? Asks Jim Meeker. Yeah.
I'm just going to look at you sadly because that's how we communicate. now we gotta round up the boys.
So we gotta round up the team.
I love. Here's more Aerosmith. Aerosmith cover. Oh. That reminds me. I still gotta get that radio telescope tattoo. I promised you all during the Cosmo Quest fundraiser, but I've been so.
What's the telescope you're gonna? What's the tattoo you're gonna get?
Just silhouette of a radio telescope. We had people vote on it, but I haven't since I moved, you know, to New Hampshire and started a new job and all the didn't have the money to do it. But I'm hoping for Christmas that I will use my Christmas money to get that tattoo for all of you fine folks who donated and voted on the tattoo.
That's brave, letting people vote on.
I told them it had to be astronomically themed, yeah. And they came up with silhouette of a radio telescope, which is perfect.
Yeah.
So yes, I will get that tattoo hopefully over Christmas break.
Sean Trevithan says the movie was a lot more fun than Deep Impact. It was more fun, just worse science. That's all.
I still have not seen Deep Impact.
It's fine.
I told you I had a thing against Taya Leone in the 90s.
Oh, really? Okay.
He was married to my crush.
Oh.
David Duchovny.
Eric W., shout out to me. Listen to Astronomy Cast in the early days before Neil deGrasse Tyson decided to steal my... Oh, Neil did not steal my thunder. Neil is the greatest. And he is just... He sets a bar, a very high bar that we have to work very hard to catch up to him. Yeah, he's as smart in real life as. Have you met Neil deGrasse Tyson?
I have.
Yeah,
it's hard. It's not hard to meet him at a AAS meeting.
Yeah. You just look for the crowd of people standing around somewhere.
Well, even at like an astronomy conference. I don't know if he does anymore, but when I was a student, he did. He'll talk to anybody.
Yeah. Yeah, no, absolute treat hanging out with him and talking to him.
One time, Phil was hanging out with him at a AAS conference, Phil Plate, and he invited me over, and I was doing this late night website coding session, trying to get our website to go live before our poster went up for the outreach project I was doing, and he's just like, seriously, you're at the bar with your laptop? I'm like, yes, Phil, go away. I love you, but this is grad school. I did not hang out with Neil at night. I'm sorry, I was boinking your daughter.
But I need you
there
to...
There was no Kerbal Space Program in 1998.
No.
I could only train them. Shout out from Virginia. Yes, that's where I went to grad school. Don't forget Token Black Guy. Aw, Token Black Guy. Uranus jokes are always funny. Oh, this isn't funny. The world's gonna end. Owen Wilson! Somebody said that earlier, but yay.
Save the world.
What you gonna do about it? What's that actor's name? I don't remember that guy. He must die early.
Yeah. Yeah. Just put them in. You could sort them in order of their star power, and that is the order that they die.
Yes. Aww. That asteroid's going to kill his mommy. He's sad. I was at NRAO in Charlottesville. Yes, that's where I did a lot of my grad student work. National Radio Astronomy Observatory. What?
Big dish.
Big dishes. Dishes and dipoles.
They're the best at what they do.
They're going to an asteroid in a shuttle.
The complaint is like, why... why would you train drillers to be astronauts when it would be so much easier to train astronauts to be drillers?
Because the everyman, Fraser.
Right.
Because the everyman. Oh, so Matthew Francis is watching Luke Cage instead of joining us with Armageddon.
I'll be watching that after this.
I need to start that, yeah. So I'm opening up a new bottle of wine. So this is Rex Goliath. Yes, this is my favorite cheap wine. It has a rooster, so all you blog-ass fans, knock, knock, No.
Sean wants to know if we saw the SpaceX Mars architecture reveal. Yup.
What'd you think?
Well, what I think was on the Weekly Space Hangout in great detail, and we actually called the title, Just Don't Break Our Heart. He's literally articulated every space nerd's greatest dream. So don't break our hearts.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
Yes, I was at a teaching workshop on how to run seminars better. So I wasn't there.
Oh, really? Yeah. Someone should have taken that advice and not let people ask the questions that they did. None of them ever want to pay taxes again.
I think you can lose the taxes of like 8 dudes if they save the world.
Yeah.
I'm okay with that.
Yeah. Why are they all in the same area?
It's basically like they're doing whatever they did to the Mercury astronauts to them just because they want to.
Yeah. Oh, lovely.
So did I.
Butt jokes.
Drill, baby, drill. Yeah, butt jokes.
Yeah, have you not seen the Q&A part of Musk's presentation?
Oh, I heard about it. Oh. This is great. Yes. Yes. I love that guy. Now, why they put them in an anechoic chamber for psychological testing is beyond me.
Well, because, you know, you can find out if they've got space madness.
Because the walls are pointy?
Yeah. Yeah.
Or to shut off? I don't know what that is about. I have spent a bit of time in anechoic chambers doing radio astronomy, so.
Yeah. Apparently they don't drive you as crazy.
Not because of psychological testing.
they don't drive you as crazy as people think.
What, anechoic chambers?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, they're silent. It's actually very nice and peaceful to be in the total silence of one of those rooms.
Yeah, it's not like complete sensor deprivation, though. That would be like, you know, floating in a dark tank and all that.
Yeah. Do you really? I still don't see what's the point of all this.
Comedy?
Yeah, I guess so.
Comedy.
Yeah.
Oh, I love you, Bear. I think he likes booty. Oh, remember the 90s and the Cubs winning the World Series was, like, impossible? Sedatives. Oh, my God.
Well, then why were they psychologically testing them? Those are not NASA astronauts.
Colonel Willie Sharp.
X-71.
He's also one of the actors in Contact. He plays the Ellie's friend, the astronomer who's also blind in Cuphead.
Is that the real vehicle assembly building? I think it is.
I can't
Yeah, I think
imagine
they're inside
doing
the actual vehicle assembly building.
Oh, I've never been. Have you?
Not inside, I've been outside it.
They've started doing allowing people in it.
Yeah.
Tweet ups, at least, on my
Not
NASA.
me, not me. I'm
No, they started
Canadian.
allowing NASA socials in there.
Yeah.
Super jealous. Watts.
Why is your TV on mute? You can put your TV on. We just can't put our TV on. You can't hear our TV. That's all.
What if we captured a small asteroid in orbit around Earth, and then if anything coming at us, we reposition it to deflect it? I'm down with that, as long as the program where we're monitoring the asteroid we've put in orbit doesn't like lose funding and then its orbit decays. I'm responding to Iron Man's comment.
Monster armadillo.
How many anechoic chambers do they have at NASA? I don't understand.
Like a big vacuum chamber or
No, like the ones with the pointy foam.
oh, I don't know. Is that what it's called?
Anechoic chamber, yeah.
People are wondering about their timer. Like you're just gonna have to find it. We are right now looking at aircraft going.
That's not helpful further.
No, I know. Well, they
We're
can.
like 41 minutes in.
Well, no, I know. The timer's there, but for people, if the timer is not what they're seeing.
We have more Aerosmith. That doesn't help.
I'm gonna flip you. I'm gonna twist you.
Do you remember the Don't Want to Miss a Thing music video that came out at this time? Because it was like Liv Tyler doing the sad thing at the screen, except instead of Bruce Willis, it was her actual father on the screen, Steve Tyler. It was ridiculous.
I think those were the test aircraft that NASA uses, though.
That's
Those,
cool. I would
yeah.
so want to do that. On Solo. No, you're not. Yeah, Owen Wilson's not hairy enough to be Chewie. Not doing it. Not feeling it.
Someone just saw some flocculent clouds. Jim Meeker saw flocculent clouds.
You go, Jim.
Well, no. If I mean, yeah, the gravity on the moon is incredibly low. The gravity
But
on an
gravity
asteroid
on
is
Ceres is
almost
so much
non-existent.
lower. Because it's so much smaller.
Yeah. So yeah, I'm not sure how people are watching this. My thought was that you would just put it on your television, watch it, and synchronize either it or our commentary. So whatever that is, if it's it's about a 20-second delay. So you just advance it by 20 seconds until you're synchronized with us.
Will the Earth be a pile of rocks? Possibly, which is fine if you're a rock or a microbe
So that question, I see what you did there, Connor.
retardigrade.
That is one of the questions asked to Elon Musk.
Oh,
Yeah.
that's right. There was a
Yeah.
burning. Got
Yeah.
it. Got it. Yeah, having only heard about it secondhand.
Yeah. That
Got
was
it.
the most cringe. Essentially, what are we gonna do with all the poop on Mars?
We're gonna make potatoes,
Yeah.
obviously. Have you not seen the Martian?
You're gonna make potatoes with them. Yeah. I mean, the reality is that poop on Mars would be one of the most useful things you could use to grow potatoes. Oh, we got three downvotes. Those are the people hoping that we were gonna live stream Armageddon, I
Sorry,
think.
dudes.
Yeah,
Is it
sorry.
we're riff tracking it.
Yeah, we're riff tracking it.
Although not nearly as funny as the riff tracks, guys. With apologies.
No, yeah. I think if
We're
we had
too
more, if we had funnier people. Yeah.
it all involves physics. It's fine. They're not made by Acme. They're made by the lowest bidder. It's fine. Rust.
Which is, that's essentially the speed of Earth orbit. So, okay. All right. This is so wrong there. I feel like I want to pause the movie, but I can't. But that velocity, the 20,000 miles per hour, that is essentially the velocity of Earth orbit. The asteroid is coming in directly towards the Earth at whatever, 20,000 miles an hour. You can't.
Yeah.
You can't connect to it.
Degrees, honey? I think it's gonna be hot in that. Razor sharp rock.
Yeah.
Susie and Nightmare.
Scary. Super unimaginable.
Burning poop man. Because that will never go badly, is remote detonating the bomb. The remote detonator never breaks. It's going to perfectly cleave.
Perfectly cleave, and one's going to go on one side, one's going to go on the other side.
They couldn't detect an asteroid the size of Texas until it was 18 days out.
Yeah.
But they could tell where the fault line is.
Exactly.
Stop. Oh, my God.
Oh, I don't want to miss a thing.
Yeah.
Is that the Saturn V?
Sexy time in the Saturn V!
So I think that's the Saturn V that's out at the Kennedy Space Center. There's out in the Visitor Center out at Kennedy Space Center.
Because it's indoors, yeah.
Yeah, there's one indoors.
Yes. Sexy time in the Saturn V.
Again, right? Asteroid coming in. You have to go around it and then catch up to it to be able to interact
with it. But no, they're
going to
catch it head on because they're like super amazing space astronauts.
Yeah. So.
Aww. I wonder if that's like a meteorite stone on the ring. That would be.
There's a chunk of Mars rock in that Kennedy Space Center.
One of my friends.
So once again,
their wedding bands do have meteoritic rock in their wedding bands.
These look like the real space shuttles. Like,
you think they filmed with the Enterprise, maybe?
Yeah, maybe. I mean, they were in the vehicle assembly building, and they've been in. So NASA clearly has given them all kinds of access in this movie.
Oh, that's so sad.
Right, and so maybe they made a big set of the space shuttle. They must have. So this is, you know.
Well, like I said, at the time, they could have used the Enterprise.
Yeah.
Because that was...
Well, I mean, could use Columbia. They were all there, right? For all the scenes where they're walking past them.
If they couldn't let them near an active shuttle, they could let them near the Enterprise.
Right, right, right. Yeah. Yeah. MMC 418. Yes, realistically, completely impossible. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, if that asteroid, I don't want to say it. I don't need to say it anymore about how if that asteroid is coming in at a direct trajectory. There's
but
no
they
way.
Can tell where the fault line is, even though they can detect it. The size of Ceres.
Yeah.
Cool. It would be kind of cool to drive around a crazy asteroid.
What is a Susie and Nightmare?
Susie and Nightmare. Like Dr. Seuss on acid. Like something that Dr. Seuss would have come up with while on acid and having a bad day.
Two shuttles. I wonder why they're gonna need two.
Roundhouse kick to the asteroid if Chuck Norris was in it. 30 seconds. Fault line. The fault line is literally a plot hole. Thank you, Sean. In 1 hour, you're going to stargaze. Clear skies in Philly.
Nice.
Rock on.
We had auroras here last couple of nights. I was out taking pictures.
We had a watch, but I don't think it's
yeah, it was
out.
Mine was going off. It wasn't great, but with the camera, we were able to see it.
Nice.
Tyler, I know the Enterprise space shuttle. So they actually made a space shuttle that was used for testing, and it was called the Enterprise. It never flew to space, but they named it after Star Trek.
There's a great picture of the space shuttle Enterprise surrounded by the cast of the original Star Trek in the late 70s.
Yeah.
But no, they did. They dropped it. They dropped it to do landing tests, but they never actually flew it to space.
Yeah.
And that was the one you could see in museums until the rest of them got decommissioned.
Oh, this is awesome. So Iron Man Australia says near the end of the credits, there's a disclaimer that NASA's cooperation and assistance does not reflect an endorsement. Yeah. No. Nicely,
you,
nicely
Ryan.
Covered, NASA.
We're going to fire you because nobody else is a terrible astronaut that can drill well that we can put up there.
Oh, we're... Whoa, he just said no gut instinct, no showboating. We're going to see a lot of that.
Yeah, right. It's a Michael Bay movie. There'll be plenty of showboating.
Eric W., this movie is the centerpiece of my Criterion movie collection. Like, right beside, like, Rear Window and Birds. D. Jonas Safko, forgot I was a maple. Yes! I'm a Canadian. Canadian.
Oh, he's got all the power. Party time! Oh, right. Nobody knows that this asteroid, the size of goddamn Texas, the size of Ceres, is on its way to hit it.
Yeah, yeah.
Nobody can see it. No astronomers ever.
Raya wants to know if we see the Northern Lights. Yeah, I just saw the Northern Lights 2 nights ago in Vancouver. We don't see it very often, but...
this is the most important part of the movie! This is the animal cracker scene!
Oh, now we got a lot of time to kill. Do you think Affleck wrote this?
I have no idea.
This feels like Affleck script.
But this sounds like a stupid, ridiculous conversation that my boyfriend and I would have, and it would be totally adorable and romantic.
Mm-hmm.
It happens. Aww. Animal cracker.
Where are you located, Ryo? San? Oh, in Wales. Yeah. You should totally be able to see it in Wales then. Yeah. Well, you're not really putting your back into it, Ryo-san. Get some kind of Aurora Alert software. You can pick it up on the internet. It'll send you an email or a text alert when an Aurora is happening. Go outside, find a good view to the north, and you should be able to see it. All the time in Wales. In the UK, they see them pretty often.
Who is this that'll send you text alerts?
Like Aurora alerts. There's tons of stuff on. I've got an app. Here's the one that
I've
got.
Now that I live in like New England, I feel like I should.
Yeah.
Sign up for one of those. Sally.
What? Data currently unavailable. Uh oh. Okay. So the app that I use, I don't know if you can see, it's called Aurora Alert, and it shows me. Shows me what the current KP is. Actually, it's pretty high right now. It's 4.
It is high. Yeah,
it's 4.67 right now. So we actually could see auroras right now.
I'm lip-syncing, so you don't get taken down.
What's that?
I'm lip singing.
Oh, no, that's. Yeah, that'll be taken. Patrick Calhoun, we are at the countdown from Armageddon is there. We're at 54 minutes.
What part of the movie? Getting chased by the armadillo.
Ben Austin wants to know how often you do a movie like this. Never.
This is the first time.
First time we've ever done this.
Yeah, let's do a station identification. So we're raising money for the Do-It-Yourself Science Zone at Geek Girl Con in Seattle next weekend. And I promised if we got to the $4,500 level out of our $6,000 fundraiser, I would watch Armageddon and live stream the commentary. And Fraser is awesome sauce and is doing it with me and hosting on his channel. So yeah.
Better not be the last. Well, okay, so here's my dream thing that I want to do is I want to do Cosmos, the old show, but not like us being snarky to Carl Sagan, because how can you? But instead, us just like updating the science and just reflecting on what the original show had, because it was so meaningful. And I would love, man, I would just love to be able to talk to Carl Sagan and just talk to him about, you know, like, we don't know what quasars are. You know, if you watch it, he's like, we're not sure what a quasar is. But
here come movies.
But we know what the quasars are. Yeah, here come the movies. A little distracted now, I think that would be a lot of fun. I felt like it might be.
There are plenty of movies for us to snark, though, if we want.
Yeah, yeah. Mr. Good Cat wants to know where you can donate. Will we be wearing a turtleneck? Yeah, we should all wear turtlenecks. Yeah,
I have turtlenecks, but I would totally wear one just for this. All right, here's the link in the chat for you guys to donate or share. When we're at $6,000, we will all do a funny song and dance and post it, those of us who are doing the Science Zone. I think I'm going to be writing the lyric. I'm going to be rewriting Danger Zone as a Science Zone song. So that might be the one we do. And yes, I will teach one of my college classes dressed as Holzman from Ghostbusters. Full costume. So... there you go.
I have no remote, only skip channels. Can't tell exactly where 54 minutes is. Well, right now they were just in the strip club.
They just got arrested outside the strip club.
So we're just watching, let's see, them go back into NASA after being at the strip club.
Can you pause it for 6 hours? I will be in bed in 6 hours. Sorry.
Yeah, can we pause it for like 6 hours? Yeah. Well, it'll be available. Somewhere. Yes. Although we're probably going to make it unlisted and then I'm going to hand this off to Nicole. So
put it on my channel. It's fine. Mm-hmm. My channel's far less professional these days.
Yeah.
I haven't used it since I teach all the time now.
We should do this online
again. Anymore. She's stronger weed in the future.
Bruce Amon.
I would be down with, well, we could hang out with Carl Sagan in Colorado and drink and smoke weed legally. There you go. Oh, people are dying. I don't like this. See, because the U.S. government didn't tell anyone there was a giant asteroid, people in other countries died.
Yep.
Even though
nobody knew.
Everyone with a telescope could see it by this point.
Bruce Heyman, so I was watching Astronomy Cast Weekly Space Hangout.
Look at the phone!
What?
Look at the Nokia!
Well, I missed it. What was it?
It was a little Nokia phone. I used to have that cell phone.
Oh, really? Oh, Iron Man Australia. I like Neil deGrasse Tyson's Cosmos. I mean, obviously, I think I should get the job for next season, but still, I think Neil deGrasse Tyson did a great job of Cosmos.
I actually didn't watch the whole... I saw a few episodes. I didn't see the whole thing.
Yeah. Well...
it was all right.
As a attempted space explainer, this stuff is hard.
Attempted space explainer.
you
should just see. I totally messed up trying to do. I'm teaching modern physics right now, and I totally messed up a problem on the board in front of the students on Friday morning. It was just like, I don't know what I just did wrong. I have no shame though, because it's like, I don't know what I did wrong. We're gonna fix this on Monday. It's fine. Your professor sometimes screws up big time.
There's the bomb. Look at that adorable little bomb. I do like that rover. That rover is
legit. That's pretty
badass. Yeah, it could go. It reminds me of the rover from Mass Effect, actually. The Mako.
See, now they're telling the world because...
Yeah. Oh, by the way, hey, everybody, you're all going to die, and we're going to save you, and you got nothing to do. Oh, man.
Twiddle your thumbs.
That is the real countdown clock, by the way.
That is
very And they countdown. Moved that.
It doesn't make that noise, though.
No, it doesn't make any noise. But they moved it to the actual museum, the Kennedy Space Center Museum. And now they got a new big LCD screen at the launch site. Yeah.
Oh, is that one of the Mercury pads? It's one of the old pads.
Where they are right now?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, probably. I mean, they're definitely on the island.
Yes, Eric, I graduated. I finished my PhD in 2012. That summer. Did we cross paths? Hang on. Let me actually use the chat because that's... You can't have a conversation with the chat. It's several minutes delayed.
Well, the problem is that people who are watching this after the fact
won't
be able to see the chat.
Yeah.
So. Oh, no. My countdown clock can't handle... Over an hour. Now it's taken the hundredths of a second. So how will you be able to...
I liked Gravity. I mean, I know the physics wasn't super great, but I enjoyed it on the big screen. Someone's talking about Gravity in the chat.
I loved Gravity. And I didn't really care about the physics problems.
Yeah.
You know? Iron Man Australia, at least you can
Apollo
speak
okay.
more than a word per minute. Aww.
I feel like Carl Sagan spoke even slower.
Yeah. Yeah.
Gravitas.
Yeah, exactly.
Gravitas I will never have.
Yeah. Yeah, when we were making our videos, Jay, my partner on it would say, "You're Brian Coxing it again."
Why does Brian Cox speak really fast or slow?
No, he just has a way of explaining things, and okay. I guess clearly it just gets into my brain, and I Brian, you know, he's like the younger version of Attenborough.
He's also adorable. Aww. Oh, this is the leaving on jet plane part.
Aww.
Oh, you worked on Armageddon.
He's Wally propulsion.
Purposely bad singing that I love. Oh, the jet plane. It's true. If it's the size of Ceres, shouldn't we be calling this a dwarf planet? In 1980, dwarf planet did not exist. Also, it's not even remotely spherical. It's like this crazy elongated Susian nightmare.
Sure, but if it was the size of Texas, it would be a dwarf planet.
And if it was spherical, which it should be if it was that
if
big.
If it's the size of Texas.
Susian nightmare.
Yeah.
It's a giant.
Yeah.
You can buy death rays. Rogue planet.
Not as president of the United States.
Somebody came up.
This is so enraging, right?
Why?
Just want to let you know, you're all going to die, but we're going to protect you. And sorry we didn't tell you.
Sorry.
You know.
Yes, but Americans don't say sorry.
Oh, right. I guess that would be like if the Canadian, the Canadian Prime Minister was, if Trudeau was presenting.
Trudeau was apologizing.
Yeah, he would be apologizing. Yeah. I'm on Vancouver Island on the west coast of Canada, halfway up the island in a small town called Courtney. Google it. Google map it. Courtney.
Google map it. And then stalk him.
And then stalk him. It wouldn't be hard.
I need to get my passport renewed. Then come.
He's like, stumble around in Courtney. Like, where's Fraser live? He's like, over there. Okay. the Amazon timer is drifting versus the stream by about 10 seconds every 20 minutes. Uh-oh. What?
Sounds like my car's clock. Oh, it's the oh, what is that called? The little Airstream that the astronauts go in. The Astrovan?
Yeah.
This movie shows Earth is a globe and not a flat Earth. Just one more round Earth or NASA propaganda. Thank you.
Yeah.
Right? Well,
was this before people had discovered the flat Earth conspiracy? 1998?
Sure.
That is the space shuttle. That is the legit space shuttle on the landing pad. They've got it. You're seeing the bottom of it with the fuel tank and the solid rocket boosters.
Or did they cut that in later?
I think the shuttle was on the pad and they were walking towards it. Like, that's the transporter there, right? Like, they're legit at NASA, right? So you don't see the shuttle because it's on the other side of that, but that's the fuel tank. And I don't know if that's the actual
gantry.
Yeah, the gantry that they walk on. But
I feel like the faraway shots are real and then the close-up shots are probably not. Yeah.
I don't know, though. I mean, big metal things like this feels like NASA.
Big metal things other than NASA, Fraser. They're not the only thing.
Yeah. No, I haven't actually been on that gantry, so I can't tell you. Yeah. But I have been near the vehicle assembly building, so some of these things are, you know.
I know a lot more about the filming of Contact with the Very Large Array.
Yeah.
I don't know anything about this movie.
Yeah.
I spent 2 summers working at the VLA, and people tell the stories. So. But we should do Contact. I have a drinking game that we came up with when we were students doing an internship at the VLA. Yeah, it's pretty fabulous. You drink every time you see the NRAO logo. You drink every time the science is wrong up until the point where they discover the alien signal, because then it just gets weird. You drink every time you see the compass. You drink every time they say small things. It's basically the entire movie. Oh, you chug during the antenna slewing or changing position. Fabulous.
Chug-a-lug. Has anybody noticed, I know there's been a few dropped frames, but has anybody noticed my audio freak out the way it has been for some of the live broadcasts? Please let me know.
Both crew rode up the same elevator simultaneously. They're on, oh my God, good point. Data Cable points out they both crews rode up the same elevator.
Yeah.
So, like, the shuttle launch pad is, like, what, miles apart?
Yeah. No, they're right beside each other.
That. Oh my God.
Yeah, why are you launching? Like, launch one, then the other. Look at them. They've, like, got a mirror of the two space shuttles.
Also, there's, like, no lighting. Why is there no, like, just like the shuttle cockpit at the beginning, there's no lighting in Mission Control.
That looks like, again, that looks like the real Mission Control room, the one that's at the Kennedy Space Center.
No, but it's not that dark. It's never that dark.
That one looks like the JPL one, but...
Yes, Contact is a great, amazing movie, and I love it. And it got me into radio astronomy. It got me into astronomy.
Yeah,
There is funny, fun parts. That
my
you can
daughter see. Loved Contact. That was like I watched that movie with her when she was pretty little, and she just loved it.
She's I saw that in theaters also around this time, mid-90s, late 90s.
Did you read the book?
Later, I read the book later.
Okay.
Really enjoyed the book. I bought it from the VLA gift shop while I was working there.
Elite Geeks wants to know, we are watching the movie Armageddon. We are at 1 hour and 8 minutes and 33 seconds into the movie.
They're launching the show.
Freedom just took off with, I mean, I love it. It's just like, it's a space shuttle with these extra big solid rocket fuel tanks on top of them or something.
Well, because they're going to an asteroid the size of Texas, which has only just been discovered.
I mixed my audio to be mono, so hopefully that works. I talked to a space shuttle astronaut, and like, you know, was it fun to launch on the space shuttle? Everyone I've talked to, they are like, no, it is not fun. It was terrifying. Yeah. Because the whole thing rattles. The forces are incredible. And you think about the people that died. And
I thought it was only like 3 G's.
It wasn't a mere 3 G's.
Yeah, on roller coasters all the time. I mean, I feel like intellectually it's terrifying and the rattling is terrifying, but I didn't realize the acceleration was
that. No, and the shaking. So it's not until it really gets up into through the atmosphere that it starts to calm down and become reasonable again. Yeah.
Well, they have a simulator at Kennedy, but it's not that scary. I think they have to tone it down.
Yeah. Rosetta happened. No, Rosetta's dead, Elite Geeks.
Wait, no, they did. Did they do it?
Yeah.
Did it crash?
Yeah, they hard landed it. They touched down on the surface of 67 Churiguri, and now it's they got some images of it, like just a few meters off the surface.
I do 3 G's in my Honda Civic. Thank you, Hercules.
Yeah.
Right? It may be more than that.
Yeah, 3 G's is a lot. Like 5G, you start to pass out. Like it's
no. What?
10 G's, you definitely are passing out.
10 G's.
Yeah, yes. 3 G's.
Gus Grissom did 16 in training. Gus Grissom's my favorite Mercury astronaut. Miko,
I do like this whole sequence with Mir. Like this is so unnecessary.
Russian space station. Yeah. Mir. Yes, this is when Mir was still a thing.
Yeah.
Physical thing.
He's got a serious case of space madness.
The poor Russians.
Oh, look at them turning.
Look at the blue and the...
Yeah. Shooting there.
How many of them threw up? He's a little space station.
Why would he need to fire his thrusters? Initiate the gravitational spin. Do you remember the time when Mir could do the gravitational spin?
When it wasn't on fire.
You know, when's the time when you don't want to set off your gravitational spin when you're trying to dock spacecraft to your space station?
You don't want to move things. He's having gravity. Because we know that we can't simulate 0G well in movies, we're going to pretend that Mir had gravity.
Yeah.
By spinning. We're going to pretend that Mir could spin and simulate.
Well, is it just like a way that they didn't have to have everyone floating around and have to spend all this time on the vomit comet?
Yeah, because that's expensive. I know Apollo 13 did that for some of its movies, which is why at the time, that was the only movie that did 0G well.
Can you imagine how hard it would be to dock?
No.
With this kind of centripetal force. Oh, madness. Like, they should have waited, then docked. And
at the same time.
Yeah, and then they could. And then
spinning, two shuttles docking.
But they they've already got gravity, just like that. Boom. Series. Gravity.
But they can't detect Ceres. No. But,
Oh, it's going. It's going so wrong. Abort! Abort!
Immediate 1G. We have 1G throughout this tiny station. This tiny station that is rotating.
Yeah.
That has no differential in the gravitational force that they're now feeling along.
And now they got full 1G.
That makes a ton of sense.
They're good to go. And like, can you imagine the forces, the torque forces on the docking pods that are holding these shuttles onto the space station as it's turning?
It's so bad. Welcome to the Russian space station in my terrible accent.
I do like him as the kind of Russian with space madness. He's been up there for 18 months. He's awesome. Yeah.
His accent is marginally better than Chekhov's.
Yeah.
Star Trek. Oh my god. Why did they use artificial gravity?
What a waste of artificial gravity. I just think like trying to do this whole sequence where everyone was floating around, they just never would have gotten it done. Like, you saw Gravity, and it was just rough to do everything in zero G.
Well, Apollo 13, they used the vomit comet when they could. Mm-hmm. But most of it, when they were just showing the upper body, they were just, like, mimicking it.
Yeah.
They just did it so well. That movie did it so well.
Yeah.
Like my Estes rocket that had no fins.
Oh, man.
Fashion.
Why doesn't he always have the artificial gravity on? Why did he just now turn it on? Like,
because of the weak Americans, obviously.
I do love just this idea that the space station is a
floating hunk of garbage.
Yeah, it's just like just about to fall apart. Because I read this great book. It was called Dragonfly, and it was just great. Like, just the same, you know, like how crazy and janky the mirror was.
It was crazy and janky, but...
About mirror?
They survived.
They did, but barely.
They didn't dock two shuttles to it.
Yeah. Yeah.
They did it. Whoa. To escape the gravitational forces of a huge plot hole. That is true, Sean.
And the fuel. What is the fuel that you're transferring? Are you transferring your liquid hydrogen or your liquid oxygen?
Uh-oh.
That's what it would be.
It broke the Russian space station.
It looks like I'm just drinking like Coke, doesn't it?
Aw.
It's not. It's a tasty stout beer.
Still drinking my wine out of my Veritas glass, although I haven't had Veritas wine in a long time. Who are native to Central Virginia.
I did a live stream on Monday with Scott Manley, who is does Kerbal Space Program. Live streaming. And he got progressively drunker and drunker over the course of the live stream. He was recreating the interplanetary transport system. Elon Musk's. It was great.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Yeah, why are they restoring all that rocket fuel up there?
After being awake for 2 days doing the CosmoQuest fundraiser.
Well, Data Cable says, why are they storing all that rocket fuel there? It's a great idea to store it up there. I mean, put a bunch of rocket fuel up in space so that you can then dock with it later and use it for other things.
Well, it's true. They were planning a piloted Mars mission with a rover. Yeah. Drill rover, according to the movie.
But fire in space. Like, watch The Martian for NASA's opinion on fire. Fire bad.
Yeah. Well, Mir had at least one fire.
Yeah, right. No brakes, Birdshot. This, we will never stop. We're going all the way through here.
It's up to you guys. I have my bladder's fine for now.
Yeah.
And my boyfriend's taking care of my dogs.
So. Just mute your video if you have to go. We'll see if I have more beer.
Mute mine if I have to go.
Yeah.
Right out there. That's weird.
Uh-oh, stream broked, says someone.
Stream borked.
Yeah.
That would do it. That would force a break.
Yeah.
You want wine and stout too. Everclear is awesome.
Did the real Armageddon happen?
Oh, he's on fire. The door is broken. A bunch of people saying it froze. What?
Yeah, my kilobits per second is like off the charts. There, it's back now.
Okay.
I have awesome internet. It is pretty high. Why is my stream going so high? What resolution are people getting on the stream? Thank you for helping me troubleshoot being an internet streamer.
Do it live!
Yeah, because it's saying... Like, I'm seeing on my side, like, 5,000 kilobits per second.
Must 2,700. Drag Jason away.
We're not moving very much. We could turn the, I could turn the resolution down. I'm running it at high def.
My, I promised my daughter I'd bring her fiance back. I can't leave him on the Russian space station.
Yeah. Even though we'd be all right if he died. That'd be okay. Oh, it's gonna blow. Do you think they actually used Mir for this?
No. That would be a whole new level. Well, no, because then they'd have to actually spin it and get gravity. And almost to the end of the Russian cosmonauts. Uh-oh. Whoops. Everything is exploding. Ooh.
Gotta move, gotta move. Dodge it!
That, is,
that was some nice piloting. Yeah, okay, it should be 720. I have a fast computer. I have a ridiculously fast internet. So
it's
I don't
okay,
know why I'm having
we
problems.
We all know your computer is very fast and very big.
For this
it's
purpose! No. I wish I was drunker.
We're not even going to talk about sound in space, because obviously.
Yeah. We're at an hour and 20 minutes. Halfway.
Why does your face look like a tomato, Fraser?
Because I'm
drinking.
Because I'm drinking.
Bunch of cowboys. Huh. Why were the shuttles not hit by debris? Because it's too, that's definitely the VLA. Because it's too early for any characters to die.
Right, right. First thing you gotta
not
do.
Not dramatic enough.
Yeah. Yeah, I can run my white balance.
That's Susie's nightmare. Look at that. Size of Texas, not even remotely spherical. In fact, it's also almost kind of aerodynamic, which makes no sense whatsoever. The physics of the asteroid is 100% movie based.
Here, watch. I'll change my white balance. But you're never going to get away from me not having a red face. Let's see. If I can turn that off. Okay, there we go. Whoa. There, is that better? I'm a little blue now.
Ships travel like airplanes.
Or we'll go like super hot. There we go. Now, if you saw me in person right now, I would have a distinctly red face. Why were Elon Musk's lips red or purple? I don't know.
They always look kind of like that, don't they?
When you stand up in front of people and you're freaking out like Elon Musk probably was, your face will often flush. Try standing in front of like 5,000 people and tell them you're going to deliver their space geek Christmas dreams.
This is normal.
4 G's! 6 G's! So many G's!
6 G's, 7 G's. Why? Why? Wait, why? Why are they going around the moon that fast? I don't understand.
Well, they need to catch up with the asteroid. So, this isn't actually, okay. You know, I mean, obviously this is terrible, but... this is how you would catch up with the asteroid. You go around the moon, and then you're going the other way now, and then you can catch up with the asteroid.
No one has passed out of 10 G's, Fraser.
No, nobody is passed out.
Nobody's passed out of 10 G's. Because they're all bad astrolers. And the Russian is laughing. Oompa Loompa Fraser!
Yeah. Because I was smurfing out.
Yay, they made it.
Oh, look at that. Smashing into the moon. Oh, there it is. It really does look like a Susie and Nightmare. Look at it. It's got like crazy
Right? It's got
Yeah.
crazy spires.
Spires. It looks like
towards the earth, even though there's no air in space.
Babylon 5, the shadows. It looks like a shadow ship from Babylon 5.
Oh my god, you're right.
Yeah. Oh, I dug. Not that I've ever heard of Babylon 5 in the newspaper in Babylon 5. I have no idea what that is. Google it. Babylon 5 newspaper. God, what was it called? I forget.
What was that newspaper called? I know.
I don't remember. Something yeah. Today.
Something about the universe?
Something, yeah. Anyway.
It cracks me up when I watch Babylon 5. I think of you.
It was a total coincidence. That is my story.
I don't know. So maybe it like has a planetary it's like eaten a planetary nebula. Like, no. Why is there so much glowing gas around the asteroid?
Because it's space, and we've seen the Hubble Space Telescope, and that kind of stuff's in space.
Space looks like, okay, fair enough.
Yeah. Whoa. Now, so where's the fuel now? They just ejected. Oh no, they've got those extra rockets up top.
Well, and they've clearly got some kind of ion engine with blue exhaust. And retrofitted. This is one place where a lot of ridiculous asteroid debris in one space makes sense, because you're right next to a goddamn asteroid.
Right, it's all coming apart, and it's also getting picked up by the it's getting picked up by the gravity of Earth. It's entering the Earth's Roche limit, so it's getting torn apart by the gravity of the Earth. So is there a way to PM Fraser? I don't know. Send me an email. myname@gmail.com. I love the maneuvers they're making, and then also when they impact an asteroid.
On the
and,
asteroid. Yeah.
Yeah, these are some up. These are some up armored shuttles at this point.
Because they had 18 days to do this.
Yeah.
Less than 18 days to armor the shuttles.
Yeah, they're gonna scrape those tiles off on the asteroid pieces.
Failed perihaps.
Sorry, but to use the moon to catch asteroid would mean you would have a periapsis that would not work. What if it was coming in directly on an orbit that you could use the moon to go around?
None of that is good.
No, there's no way you can do this.
Ugh.
So remember, zero gravity, no...
Things are falling.
Things are falling in zero gravity, yeah.
Well, so it looked like the shuttle was being hit by stuff and the pilots were going through the windshield, so maybe the pipes are moving forward.
Yeah. No more stout for Fraser. Fraser's got a little more stout left.
Oh my god.
No, it's all... It's almost.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, no, it was like maybe a third when I got it, when I started tonight. So,
oh no, sadness.
They should do a more realistic remake of this movie. Yeah,
a more realistic remake of this movie is
It would be very boring.
Putting a solar sail on it, watching it,
shooting it with a laser. For about 200 years.
Speed up 20 years.
Look. Yeah. We've calculated now that in 4,000 more orbits, it won't hit the Earth. Yeah. Hang tight.
I think you're like half a second ahead of me.
Am I?
Let's see. Because you said hang tight right before they said hang tight.
So how much? It says I'm at 103.06 to go.
103.09. Yeah, you're like 3 seconds ahead of me.
Okay, so
it looks like you're predicting the line.
Okay, hold on. So I'm going to pause for 5 seconds. Okay,
fine.
Here
it's
we
fine.
Go. No, here we go.
All right, fine.
2, 3, 4.
Go,
five.
Go,
okay.
Go, 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 go.
102.53.
I'm at 102.49. 48.
Okay, 40. We're close enough now. Okay. Crashing stops. Have you got the closed caption on?
No, I do not.
It's very helpful.
Is it?
Yeah.
I recently, I have to admit, I put on closed captioning because I was watching Broadchurch, And apparently I can't watch British TV shows without closed caption.
And I turn on closed caption all the time. Yeah, I'm drinking stout. I'm drinking the Gladstone Brewery Stout here in from Courtney. A 20-hour really boring remake.
Here's the other shuttle. They died, Buscemi. They died. All right, I put it on. Off the grid. They died.
You see what I mean? You just catch the dialogue. Yeah. It really helps. Yeah. Thanks, Angels in Action.
Fire.
Is that spam? I don't know.
But it looks like good spam. Liv Tyler is capable of doing any acting. Not in this movie. She gets like four lines.
She was good. She was good in Lord of the Rings.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm saying in this movie, she doesn't get any. Yeah. Hi, Michael.
Hey, Michael. I don't know. I guess this is a thing that we're going to have to do at the Eclipse meetup next year. We'll play some movie and we'll all just hang out and watch it.
Yeah, I haven't decided what I'm doing for that. I may just grab a plane ticket. Yeah. I have nowhere to go. I have no family and no house because I live on an oil ship.
Oh, I thought you, you know somebody at Pamela's house. Pamela.
I will probably be crashing with somebody in Edwardsville.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
I don't know if I'm officially signing up for the trip or if I'm just going to rent a car and follow you guys.
That sounds legit. It's
entirely possible. I love you guys, but I'm probably just going to hang out and drink with local friends and not do the whole conference thing.
So once again, they are landed on the asteroid. How much gravity would you have on the surface of Ceres?
I don't know off the top of my head, but it'd be a lot less than the moon, which is 1.6.
Yeah, like 15%. It's probably like 4%, maybe 1%.
Well, I like how they're complaining about the magnetic fields, which he's like, we're on iron, except that in order to generate a magnetic field, you need some kind of liquid metallic thing, which an asteroid does not have. Whatever, fine.
Oh, I don't think that that spaceship is getting off that asteroid.
Wow. Okay, so Ceres gravity is 0.27 meters per second squared, which is, thank you, Google. The movie's still running in the background on them.
Okay, Google. What is the gravity of Ceres?
Like 3% of Earth? If I did my maths correct just now? 3%?
0.27 meters per second squared.
0.27? Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's about 3%.
Yeah. Okay.
It's like gravity. 3% Earth's gravity. Hi, Tim. Yeah.
So remember, every step they take, they would be going 30 times further. They could lift
the rover.
Yeah, you could lift anything. You want to pull some metal off somebody? No problem.
Nobody left. They all just died. Except for Bear.
Oh, magnetic boots. Shut up. Right, of course. Yeah, they got gravity boots.
Magnetic boots will work.
Crump, crump, crump.
An iron asteroid. That would work.
Yeah.
No, but a Texas-sized iron asteroid doesn't make any sense either because Ceres is not iron. It would have differentiated it that freaking size.
Michael, this movie's on Netflix, and I've got it here in Canada. So if you don't have Netflix, just go to, you know, if you can't get your hands on Netflix, just go to 132 in the movie. Armageddon. Can gravity boots exist? Magnetic boots for sure.
Magnetic, but that doesn't use gravitational force.
No, it just keeps your shoes.
Black holes in your shoes.
Yeah, it would just be attach your shoes to the ground. And then you'd have to like...
Can a metal object make a magnetic field if it's spinning? See? Seussian nightmare! That's where it comes from.
The countdown is going up. We have the countdown from Armageddon. So in other words, when Armageddon began.
Magnetic field.
YouTube probably has it too. We only suggest legitimate ways of watching this movie. Purchase this work of art.
People are hating on Owen Wilson.
Oh, I like Owen Wilson.
Adorable moves.
Although I thought Zoolander 2 was just unwatchable.
Not even trying.
No, couldn't do it. Zoolander 1 was fine.
Magnets work. ICP.
Friggin' outer space. Man, that...
Friggin' space, man.
Friggin' space.
Because it's an asteroid. You haven't seen it because it's an asteroid. You've been on Earth.
So, okay. So let's just do a quick math here, right? Size of Texas...
Size of Texas.
So it's like, what, 1,000 kilometers across?
I don't know. How big is Texas?
How big is Ceres? Okay, Google.
How big is Texas?
Diameter of Ceres.
I was going to say radius, but okay.
950 kilometers. So
they have to drill 455
kilometers down to hit that, well, to go in that fault line, right?
So do they have a cable that long and a drill bit at the end of it? Because there's no way they have like a metal tube that's that long.
Yeah. Carla Thompson. That is no, you purchase a legitimate version of the movie. It's on Netflix. It's free.
Netflix isn't free, dude. You have to pay for Netflix.
Well, sure. You gotta pay for Netflix, but then it's on Netflix.
Okay.
Should I take another drink?
Netflix isn't free. We're okay to go. Not Ellie Arroway. It's fine.
Yeah. Jack D42. Yes, it's live.
Uh-oh. Someone's seeing a repeat.
You might have... accidentally gone back to the beginning of the stream, Ryo-san.
Well, they're not. Ryo's not going to hear that.
Why is there a machine gun?
Because America. America, Fraser.
Why is there a machine gun?
By the way, you should know this. Oh my god. Okay, Ryo's back. Good. Kicks an asteroid. Yeah, so they have a drill that has to go 450 kilometers into not Ceres. Except if it's not. Okay, so here's.
They just need to hit the fault. They just need to make it down into the fault.
And it's not spherical. It's elongated Susie and Nightmare.
Mm-hmm.
So there's probably a much smaller.
Right. It's like this right. It's got this tiny little.
We're actually explaining Michael Bay's.
Right. And you know what? Actually, it makes sense with the science as we now know it. It's duck shaped, right?
Except the duck is not the size of Texas.
Right, but it is duck shaped the size of Texas, and then it has this thin little join where two amalgamations of rocks kind of came together. Right? It's matching the science as we now understand it.
No.
Yeah, Michael Bay was way ahead of his time. Way ahead. He knew about this common arrangement of asteroids.
That is the weirdest spam I've ever seen.
That's a spam. It's a hell of a spam. How did you pull that off, Trace?
Oh. Time out by Jim. Thank you, Jim. So glad somebody with a wrench is paying attention.
Now, why is the radio darkness? Why? Okay.
Oh, I'd have to pay attention to the movie.
Oh, right. Because plot. Because then they won't be able to detonate the nuke.
Because plot. Oh, I feel bad for Jack. He just watched The Martian, which had good physics, and now you're watching Armageddon, which is terrible physics.
Yeah.
I like how the asteroid has like these plateaus.
Yeah. Where was all that jagged rock? Didn't you do some training? Haven't you got a machine gun? Still, think. That thing looks awesome. Gotta say.
The rover? The
Yeah.
drill rover thing?
I
Yeah,
like
sure.
it.
Rio. Gotcha, Rio.
How do you get space dementia? Whew. That's the greatest risk of going to space, is you get a little space dementia.
That is one facet that has not been totally well explored, I feel like, for long-term mission planning.
People have been in enclosed spaces being overly stressed in all kinds of situations. In Antarctica, in submarines. It's just nonsense. Space dementia.
See, but they're not up there long enough for space dementia. They're
No.
just like the general stress of the entire world's survival is on their shoulders, and they became astronauts 2 weeks ago. That's their issue.
Radio dark is the asteroid is spinning on all three axes. Okay.
Because it's spinning on all three axes.
If you hit pause during live and then unpause, it's still live. Well, you just click the live button and you'll come back.
Yeah, hit the live button, and then
Yeah.
it'll come
You
back.
what or you could pause your movie and our stream at the same time. Gravity is strong on this asteroid.
Get rid of the phone.
How I thought they had to go through radio silence. Didn't they just
Well,
say they couldn't talk
he's
to them?
on a phone with a windy cord, so
Oh, right.
clearly
Okay.
that can go through space.
He's got space madness.
That's space madness. He has I'm stressed out madness. Totally reasonable.
Don't push the shiny red button. That was a Ren and Stimpy reference. Just didn't it?
No, went over my head.
Right.
It was not happy, happy, joy, joy,
Yeah.
or Wimpy's belly button. So
Space madness.
I like when they went into a black hole and they found all the lost socks. I think that was my favorite Ren and Stimpy episode.
Jack D40 wants to know if it's ironic that humans are contemplating terraforming Mars while we can't even control our own climate. No, no way. Colonizing Mars is going to be way easier
No. He said
than
terraforming,
terra.
not
Yeah, no,
colonizing.
whatever. Terraforming and colonizing Mars is going to be way easier than the mess we've got ourselves into here on
No,
Earth.
there's no way terraforming Mars is going to be scientifically easier than
Than fixing Earth's
fixing the
climate?
climate on Earth.
I don't
Yes, at least
know.
you have a starting point. Terraforming? Okay. If you had several centuries, terraforming
Right.
more reasonable, maybe. But no. That's a lot harder. Oh, and your
Log
Netflix doesn't have
from
Armageddon
Blammo.
on it. Michael's in the UK.
Yeah, I'm amazed the UK doesn't have Armageddon because we have it here in Canada and we get nothing. Like, this whole thing hinged on me being able to find Armageddon on Netflix.
They haven't drilled the hole.
No, sir. I don't
Gotta
like
blow it
it.
up anyway.
The drilling isn't working.
So they can't,
All I'm
they
hearing is
can't,
Mass Effect. When I hear this guy talk, I just hear Mass Effect.
communicate with the crew, but they can set off a nuke.
Right.
Just want to point that out.
Yeah.
Just want to point that out.
Top secret. That bomb in there.
That's what he said? He said? That's what they said. I'm ruining Fraser's YouTube channel.
What?
Nothing.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just gripped by the movie. Didn't even hear a word you said.
Was making dirty jokes on
Oh.
your YouTube channel.
If it's
What
not
else
on
is
my
new?
YouTube channel, we're gonna shut this whole thing down and then save
Put it
it and
on
put it
my
on your
channel.
YouTube channel. Nathaniel Sanchez, like, what? What is going
What's going on?
on? What have I walked
We
into?
don't know. We are live commentating Armageddon. You should join us. We're at, what point in the movie are we at?
We're at one. Oh, we're at 47:21 to go.
47:18 to go on Netflix. My God, there's still 47 minutes.
I know. I don't know why I said yes to this.
No. You didn't just say yes. You volunteered.
I did. You said something like, hey, do you want to do this? And I'm like, oh my God, in, I believe is what I said.
Oh my God.
Secondary protocol.
How do you turn it off? How do you turn off the nuke? How do you turn off the nuke? I don't even know.
Your dogs are excited.
Look at all the pointy crystal bits. Like, it's like they're inside a geode. All the pointy crystal bits. I don't understand the geology of the pointy crystal bits.
Can you hear this dog going crazy behind me here?
No.
Ah. Okay, hold on.
We shouldn't be here. Now, Steve Buscemi going crazy is just Steve Buscemi.
Oh, we can see. Oh, well. There was a dog just going berserk.
Where's my popper? Macy! I don't know where Macy is.
This movie is so long. We've gone so far. We've got to go around the horn, Nicole. We can't stop now. Kill the uplink.
Yes. NASA's kind of in charge of the communications that they can't have with the people, but apparently they can use to set off the bomb.
Uh-oh. Trace is about to show us another... of his penis? Favorite things, probably another penis. Yeah,
it was a penis. I missed it. All I saw were.
But
like,
last time, Trace shared a penis. But
oh, okay.
And then he'll probably.
Okay, I know what penises look like. You're fine. Yeah. It's fine. I don't need to see that. Not to mention, I feel like the large nuclear.
What are you doing with a gun? He's saying, "What are you doing with a gun in space? Why do they have a rover with a machine gun in space?"
America.
America. Yeah. Oh.
If we do 2001 Space Odyssey.
Yeah. Then I'm out.
It's a good movie. Contact is also a great movie. But there's still things you can make fun of. Especially if you spend way too much time around radio telescopes.
Oh.
He broke the bomb. Oh.
Oop. Bonk.
Wrench beats gun every time.
The override has been overridden. Whoa.
God, I love you, Bruce Willis. This is where Bruce Willis had some hair.
Yeah.
But he's still sexy with his balls. He's a good-looking man. What can I say? This Space Cowboys, that's another great ridiculous space movie.
I have never seen it.
I saw that. I feel like I saw that in theaters too. Little Gary Busey's in Contact. Why do I not remember Gary Busey being in Contact?
Well, his kid is the one who blows up the the first machine.
Oh, okay.
Wow.
This is amazing.
Oh, someone said, don't say the wake up word for Google. I guess I activated everybody's Googles.
Seriously?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, I talk to my Google all the time. Works pretty well. Whoa.
Phrasing.
Phrasing. Is that still a thing we say? Phrasing?
Jake Busey. Okay. Oh, my God. So, fun story about Gary Busey. My friend Maria has a drone that the instructional video for the drone is narrated by Gary Busey. And it's amazing.
Oh, that sounds great.
Yeah.
I mean, is it surreal?
His son Jake Busey's in it, but yes. Yeah. No, that is a real drone video. Uh-oh. They turned the bomb back on. You convinced him with the wrench around his neck. Yeah. He should turn the bomb off.
Okay, so is this hilarious that it's like turned into a diffuse that bomb?
Good job.
Come on, which wire is it? Is it the red wire or the blue wire? Which wire?
Is the other skill that astronauts are trained in is defusing bombs? All of them.
Red. No, wait. Blue.
Is it red with blue stripes or blue with red stripes?
Whew.
Thank you. Nukes, you cannot access the panels to the ignition sequence with a screwdriver. For obvious reasons. Thank you.
Yeah, you don't just defuse a nuclear bomb like that. I got some magic happening. That, I believe, is the technical term, right? I have some magic happening. Is that what radio... You're a radio astronomer. Is that what you guys say? Have some magic happening?
Magic all the time. Yes. Yeah. Science is just magic, you guys. There's no math or reason. It's just magic. Oh, my goodness.
We got a hole to dig up here. Yeah! Doomed us all.
Oh, hole. Do-do-do-do-do-do.
Jimmy Kerr just wants someone to see someone cut the wrong wire in one of these movies.
End of the movie. They're like walking next to the rover now. I love bear. Stargate? Oh, that's a great suggestion.
Yeah, I like Stargate. Oh my God. Again, I wonder how many people are actually watching the movie with us. Like, I have no idea what this experience is like.
It's probably terrible if they're not watching the movie.
Yeah, if you're not actually watching the movie.
Somebody mentioned Sonic Screwdriver.
There, now you can throw a rock in the very low gravity.
I never saw Star Wars.
Yeah, look at these, like, spires on it.
Right?
Yeah.
Like, what is the geological significance of ridiculous crystal spires? The nuclear warhead. Slim Pickens. I love the Doctor Strange love reference.
Yeah. How I learned to love the bomb.
How I learned to love the bomb. Power between my legs. Somebody mentioned that.
Paul Stern says it's hilarious not watching the movie.
Oh my God. Oh, I'm a baby frog here. So they can walk normally in the gravitational environment of their Texas-sized asteroids.
Yeah.
But they will jump a rover across a giant ravine.
Right.
Okay. They're going to be heroes. Like the Russian hero. Mini-me, quit humping the warhead. Yes, Jack, it is on Netflix if you're in the U.S. or Canada, apparently. And like the AG chattering was just the closed captioning.
I love, like I said, I've watched almost everything on Netflix now with closed captioning. The other thing I do is I've got a plugin on my Chrome browser that lets me speed up the speed of things. And okay. So I will often watch shows as they start to get boring at like double speed with closed captioning on.
I used to do that with podcasts.
Yeah. Yeah, I do it with YouTube videos, too.
Jack is Canadian.
Right on.
Jack, you should be able to watch it on Netflix.
Yeah, go Canada. I'm Canadian. I'm watching on Netflix.
They're floating into outer space.
floating into outer space.
Because you can walk normally, but you can drive a rover off. Oh my god. Yes. Connor says, the science is ridiculous, says the lady with the sonic screwdriver.
You have a sonic screwdriver. That's lovely.
Nobody mentioned sonic screwdriver. I happen to have one. So, yeah. Which I used when I actually defended my dissertation and became a doctor. So, there you go.
Did you have to defend the sonic screwdriver?
I had to, like, point it at my committee and be like, I know science. It was only terrifying science.
If they're tumbling in three dimensions, Sterox 13. If they're tumbling in three dimensions, how come the Earth is always perfectly on the horizon?
We gave up trying to explain the movie physics.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, we have departed from the science.
We should have had Emily Lakdawalla because she could explain why this asteroid would have crazy spires of crystal dew.
Oh, there you go. Use the machine gun.
Is my go-to.
So which is it, people? Is there no gravity? Is there Earth gravity? Which is it? Just because you're like a little...
Well, it's a variable gravitational field.
Right. Because, like, it's floating like it has no gravity. And now it's on the ground... So now it has gravity again.
Oop. I love you, Bear.
Okay, so the Russian guy is Peter Stormare, a great character actor. He's actually Swedish. So there you go. The Russian guy is actually Swedish. So that is his accent.
Swedish is not the same as Russian.
But I know. That's his Swedish accent.
I don't think that's a Swedish accent.
No, he's a Swedish actor, though, trying to fake a Russian accent. Trying to
fake a Russian accent. It's only slightly better than Chekhov.
Yeah.
It's fine.
Yeah.
It's fine. Let's do it live. It's fine. Break it. Oh, dear. Who gave Buscemi the gun? Trauma-dependent gravity.
Why? Why is there a machine gun? Why is there a machine gun?
Because that's how we fix things. By shooting them. Magnetic wheels.
Man, if the aliens showed up, they would have a surprise.
That's right. Whee! There he goes, the low gravity. We can fly further.
This is insane. That is it. That is this movie.
This is insane. This is a terrible idea.
Yeah.
How much time left in the movie? Too damn much.
34 minutes and 10 seconds. Oh, although you're going to have to shift for whatever time for you.
Right.
Earthquake!
Except it's not. Okay, no, that's fine. Nope, it's fine. It's not Earth, but that's fine.
So why is this happening?
Because Steve Buscemi shot it. And the green crystals can't handle the violence.
Yeah. Look at those rubbery green crystals, like, flopping around.
I'm going to go ahead and guess the green crystals are olivine because planetary scientists go crazy for olivine. That's a thing.
Space dementia.
Max! Oh, no!
Oh.
No, not Max. We like Max because he loves his mommy.
He loves his mommy. Take care.
Max is gone with the drill. I love you, Max.
Unfortunately, I can't show you the time. If you hold your mouse over the sort of where the red dot is on Netflix, it'll show you what the current time is.
Well, it'll show you if you can hit it exactly, but it's only like approximate for me.
Yeah, no, it's true. They don't show you the count up time. But we have no way to show you the countdown time. I guess we could. If we had started and I counted down from the length of the movie, then people would have been able to find it better. These are the things that you learn as you do. This is why we run this my crazy experiments.
Yeah.
This was, again, a thank you to the people who have donated to the Do-It-Yourself Science Zone for Geek Girl Con this weekend. Sorry, next weekend.
Yeah.
We reached $4,500 out of our $6,000 goal, and I said I would watch Armageddon and live stream the commentary. So here it is. I will post a link for that in the chat again.
Everyone's waiting. So, I don't know if you heard, we were doing Astronomy Cast, and we were talking about the cryovolcanism, the cryovolcanic geysers.
Okay.
And so Tac Tang in the chat suggested the name Chrysers.
Is that not a thing?
It's not a thing. I Google searched it. It's nowhere. I'm planning it's to make VLA. It stick.
I swear to God, that's the VLA. Sorry.
Oh, was that the VLA?
Yes, it was the dishes again, which is not used for communications.
I'm making it, the point is I'm making it stick. If you hear the word Chrysers from here on out, it's because we pushed it.
So I'm actually teaching a planetary science class right now. I will introduce that to my students.
Yeah, as the term.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, cryovolcanic
geysers. Wow. Boom. Goodbye, France.
I don't know if they take Bitcoin. I don't know how it works. Three hours away, they're going to try and bust up this.
What do you know? It hit another landmark.
They're going to evacuate. Where are they going to evacuate to? Ceres is about to hit Earth.
Yeah, it's a global killer.
Where are we going to evacuate to?
Oh, I should fire up Universe Sandbox and drop Ceres into Earth. See what happens.
See what happens.
I know what happens.
You can screen. I'm sure you can screen share that.
It turns red and on fire is what happens.
So you can't evacuate.
It wrecks your planet.
There is a PayPal donation page.
Oh, Trace is about to get banned.
What is that? It just looks like squares.
Yeah, I don't know. Chrysers.
Chrysers.
Yeah.
Oh, we just wait. Yeah, they're saving the world. We lost Max.
Max. Got a hole to make.
Is the satellite of an asteroid a satelloid?
A satelloid?
It should be.
Yeah, it's a good one.
It should be.
I have not tried Universe Sandbox in VR. I'd love to, though.
Sounds fun. Michael, Joe Biden is a bomb.
That's six words.
Because drillers can't count, apparently.
Yeah.
You can be... I'm going to jump. 250 feet. Wait a second. Wait a second. We're 450-kilometer asteroid.
Yeah, yeah. Can they dig 450 kilometers in an hour? That's the number we need them to go to. Not 250 feet.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Yeah. It's the size of Texas. It's the
size of Texas. 250 feet matters.
Yeah. I mean, if they just hadn't said it was the size of Texas, if they'd said it's 10 kilometers.
That would have been fine.
Yeah, it would be ridiculous. If they said it was 1 kilometer.
The movie would have been fine.
Yeah.
The science would have been fine. Yeah. We don't really care about it killing microbes. All we care about is it killing humanity. It doesn't need to be that.
But I could just imagine, right? People watching this and like Michael Bay going like, yeah, but you know, it needs to be bigger because wouldn't there be gravity? And so they just were like having
Texas
to change the story to
use Texas.
Yeah, we gotta use Texas. Methane.
Wait, it has methane pockets? Well, because it came from the outer solar system where there's lots of methane.
No, it didn't come from the outer system. It was dislodged by the comet. Well, they were very clear on the science here, Nicole.
Oh, right. It did come from the asteroid belt. You're right.
Yeah. How's your wine doing?
It's delicious.
How's the rest of the bottle?
Oh, I didn't get very far into
Okay,
I'm
good.
A lightweight. I'm a super lightweight.
Oh, are you? Okay.
Okay, that's actually a lot for me.
That is a lot. That's a lot for me.
I'm a lightweight. I'm like 5'1". Everything's bigger in Texas.
All right, here we go. What's your depth?
It has to be exactly.
Yeah, it has to be exactly 250 feet. If it's not 250 feet,
it won't reach that perfectly precise fault line that they've found on the asteroid that they couldn't see. That was the size of Texas!
Cryo geysers. Yeah.
Fine. Oh my god. They made it happen! They drilled the hole!
250!
Now they gotta get the bomb in the hole. They've got 38 minutes, or else the Susian nightmare.
Was that Michael Dorn?
What? No, stop. Did I miss Michael Dorn?
I don't know. Just look like Michael Dorn.
I don't want to go back, because I'll be out of sync.
You can't. Yeah, no, you can't. You got to go forward. Just look like Michael Dorn for a second there, is all I'm saying.
Michael Dorn is amazing. He's adorable without the Klingon bridges. Are they going to send him down the hole now? To get the crushed PVC. There's a lot of gas pressure.
A lot of gas pressure.
On the asteroid. What is that? What is with the sulfur?
There's explosion-y flame with the tidal forces. It's entering the Roche limit.
It's well inside the Roche limit if it's 38 minutes away. Come on.
What's the Roche limit of Earth?
I don't know.
I just did a video on this. I forget now.
Really?
Yeah, like 9,000 kilometers or something. It's not far.
You're right. Yeah. Here's three. 9-4. There's 25 minutes of the movie left, but at least some of it's credits, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
You're gonna have to. Nicole and Fraser ruin science movies. No, science movies ruin themselves.
we just pointed out.
Where Europa has cryo geysers or geysers. No, but the yellow geysers made it look like Io. That's just random.
Well, wait a minute. Now gravity's reversed? What's going on?
Well, he jumped. And he got stuck on a cryo geyser. What? On a sulfur geyser.
So which is it? Like, gravity's got to choose here. Come on, gravity. Cool. Make up your mind.
Variable gravitational field, because it's got pockets of metal that are denser, and...
Okay, so now gravity's falling. Now gravity works the way you expect.
Gravity is falling.
Gravity's pulling?
All I know is those olivine crystals are getting destroyed.
See, look at this. There's so gravity's pulling everything down so strongly that occasionally people are floating up into space. the exact same moment. The gravity is repulsive and the gravity is attractive. This is crazy. Well,
I think there was a dark energy spike.
Yeah, you know what? Gravity is like is as dangerous as it needs to be right now. That's what it is. How you know what is the strength of gravity? Whatever is the most dangerous. It's like Godzilla, right? How big is Godzilla? He's as big as he needs to be.
Big as he needs to be be terrifying.
Yeah, if Godzilla needs to step on your tank with his foot, he can. If he needs to hold you in one hand, he's there. He's got you.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Error. Now there's a bomb error.
Bomb is dead. Someone's going to have to go down and start up that bomb manually.
Oh my god.
You press the button.
I'm actually hyperventilating here.
Oh no. Breathe.
That's some bad news. Gravity broke on the asteroid. That's the bad news.
The remote detonator on the bomb has been damaged.
Somebody's gonna have to stay behind.
She's like, it's my dad. It's my dad.
You're BFFs with everyone on there, but especially your dad and your fiance. It's gonna be one of them, obviously. leaving on jet plane. Oh. The Russian, the sweetest Russian is going to volunteer because he's the real hero. No one's going to leave you with the bomb, Buscemi. No one's going to leave you.
That's
with
his space dementia talking.
Oh my God.
Whoa.
Where did they cut out those wires? Were those important?
And different colors. Like, were those wires... Was one of those wires from the transmitter?
That's why the transmitter was broken.
That's why the transmitter doesn't work. He had a bunch of wires cut.
I like that we actually have a nuclear expert in the chat. D. Jones is like, no, you can't manually set up a nuclear bomb. No, D. Jones has been giving us the nuclear bomb facts, which makes
have you seen Manhattan? Rad. The TV show about the nuclear bomb?
No.
No, it's really good. Yeah.
It's there got you go. A button. It's like a video game. Basically, nuclear bombs are like video games. You just press the
lift, press, hold. It's pretty hilarious that they would have a like a handle to detonate a nuclear bomb.
I heard my dog. I heard my dog shaking. Oh my God.
See you later.
Bye. He's like, Oh, crushing the olivine crystals. The green crystals are the best part. Tell Grace that I love her. I'll always be with her. I'll be a creepy stalking ghost.
Oh, this is it. This is his chance to murder him.
But he loves his daughter. He wants her happy.
Yep.
That's the sweet part. Oh.
That's your job.
That's your job. Oh,
Che Wan, no, we're watching the movie Armageddon, and that's how far into the movie we are right now. Read the description. So we are 2 hours and 12 minutes, like we're literally near the end.
Hit control alt delete to stop the bomb. Oh my God. Bust or bust. We actually have a Harry in the chat. Go Harry. Mm. Armageddon goes great with corn dogs and barbecue sauce. I'm down with that. And wine and ice cream. I had an entire pint of Haagen-Dazs because I have no self-control.
Did you go? That's a healthy dinner.
I got the, yeah. Well, my mom was supposed to visit this weekend and then she got sick and couldn't come. So all the ice cream I got for her, I had to take one for the
team. Someone had to take that one for the team. Sorry, Daddy? Mom. Oh, I thought the radios didn't work.
Well, they worked again.
Mm.
It's fine. Do it live. Oh, he's got something.
Oh, he's going to have to break that promise.
So sad. I want to be like you. I want to be a bald badass.
Wow, we got 70, a whole bunch of people just showed up here. I'm so sorry that this is what you're watching.
They're like, what? We thought we were watching something entertaining. We're watching these two fools.
Yeah. All right, I'm going a little more.
A little more stout.
A little more stout.
A little more stout.
The magnetic boots, they do nothing.
The asteroid's made of green crystals.
Green crystals. Should have brought their crystal.
But it's fine. Mm. It's fine. Do it live. It's fine.
Is that it? That's now what you're going to say for everything?
Do it live?
Do it live.
That's what I've been saying forever. Ever since. Okay, so story. Scott Segler was doing a hangout on air a while back, and he was having trouble, so he calls me, because I apparently know how those
technical support, Nicole speaking.
So he just kept, every time something went wrong, he just yelled, do it live! And his business partner, A, was just like, ah! Ah! So yeah, that's why I do it. It's fine. Daddy, no! I'm sorry. Goodbye. Bruce Willis, I'm so sorry. I'm so sad. That's all the acting she gets in this entire movie. All that talent, she gets one scene.
Some other live stream must have just ended. Yeah, a shorter movie, and now they've moved over to this one.
They're like, what the hell's happening?
Yeah.
It's raining rocks. Aw, thank you, Jack. We're effing awesome.
Aw. Nicely done, so you didn't trip my filter.
Well done. The Russian cosmonaut is very upset and going to fix everything. This is the best line coming up. Somebody already posted this in the chat a little while back about American parts and Russian parts that are made in Taiwan. It's components, American components, Russian components, made in Taiwan. Quoting the movie won't get us taken down, right?
What? Quoting the movie? No, I don't think so. It's fair use.
What difference does it make if they don't blow it up? I'll blow it up.
I'll blow it up. I'm going to blow it up.
I'll kill you. I'll kill you.
It's getting bad. That's your Roche limit.
I have to take you away if you don't move. That's what I say to my dog. I have to move you. The Russian space station! Bark, 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 bark.
Well, I fixed it.
I can't. Oh, there's so many things I've actually fixed that way, though. Either hitting it, like how many electronic or mechanical things that I have fixed by hitting it or unplugging it and plugging it back
this
in.
This is a comet.
It's not a comet.
Although. Wasn't it you who was saying at some point there's like almost no distinction between what's an asteroid and what's a comet? Like, it's a pretty blurry line these days.
There are some objects that have been found that were thought to be asteroids that turn out to outgas and give off volatiles when they get close to the sun. So, yeah, there seems to be a blurry line between asteroid and comet.
Yeah, what's an asteroid? It's a spectrum now.
Yes, it's a spectrum, which is great because I have to teach this. They keep changing this stuff as I teach, and I'm like teaching introductions.
Just call them like cometasteroids.
Comroids.
Yeah.
Comroids.
Yeah, and just merge the two terms together.
Comroids sounds like something you should see a doctor for.
Possibly. Which you should.
Oh my God.
Percussive. We're going to go back. We're going to do it ourselves.
Thank you, Data Cable. Yes.
Come on. Press the bomb. Oh, this is it.
Press the button. Let us get off the cometroid. Don't blow up Harry. Let Harry blow up himself. Because Bruce Willis is such a badass.
Official NASA instruction is apply the lunar boot. He doesn't know how to fail.
That's great. Except it's okay to fail in science. Except when there's an asteroid heading for you.
Just Like, look at the sort of the size of the Earth and where that barrier is, like the delta V that would be required
To push that
to
away, yeah.
push in those directions.
But they have a very scientifically determined fault line,
Yeah.
so it's fine.
But literally.
Look at that
Yeah, boom, crack. Look at it break in
shockwave.
half perfectly. That's 'cause 250 feet down. They were very precise.
Oh my God. You're no push button. I push in. You push the button. I push
Oh,
the button.
Comroid cream is what I need.
It's not your turn. It's my turn. Comroid
Most of the
cream.
small particles have been vaporized. Asteroid the size of Texas
You
could have been
know,
any other size, and it wouldn't
being
have been
destroyed
completely
by the debris.
ridiculous.
Like the little bits of asteroid debris following it just happened to follow the asteroid
Yeah.
pieces
Yeah.
and not crash into the Earth.
Yeah. Boom. Bifurcated.
But not just
Oh.
bifurcated. We're all celebrating, but my dad died, and that sucks.
Yep. He was in there. That does look like the John. That looks like the Kennedy Space Center. This shot.
Except they turned all the lights off. So I do
Well.
know. So for the very for contact, the very large array, the control room for the VLA in the movie looks really similar to the real one. Like I couldn't tell the difference, and I spent a little time there. They built a completely different control room for the movie. So it's possible they built a different control room for this.
Oh,
It
look at all
looks
these
really.
people who didn't have to die.
Yeah, well, and all the little kids, because Michael
Yeah.
Bay loves to show little children who don't die. Wait, we've got to
I
have
think
more
we made it.
drama.
I think we're on the home stretch now.
But there's more dramatic music, so something else could go wrong. Yeah, but you never have to pay taxes again, so it's fine. Oh, okay,
Look at the land. Why did they punch?
before.
Why did they have to punch the glass?
Because they were sick and tired of this ridiculousness.
Riley Atwood, what is happening? We are watching the movie Armageddon. And we are 2 hours and 21 minutes. We're literally at the very. Why do they have to jump out and go down the slide?
Because it's fun. You just saved the world. Wouldn't you want to use the inflatable slide? Wait, here's the badass walking scene.
The one thing that's cool is that they didn't
Molly
kill everybody down to one person. Like, that's the way you would normally do this. So.
What? What, like Ben Affleck would have to land the shuttle by
Yeah,
himself?
by himself, because every person had been pulled away one by one until they were all dead.
Even Michael Bay is not that ridiculous. Oh my God. Yeah, it's a good thing none of the asteroid debris damaged the shuttle tiles. Ooh, Jim Meeker. It's too soon.
Oh, too
It'll always be
soon.
too soon for that.
Yeah.
But it's totally true. Oh, he gets to hug his kid because his wife takes him back for whatever
No.
reason.
Oh, you
I
saved the world. You're
saved
all
the world.
right.
I guess that works.
This shuttle do not have those stupid slides. You don't know. You don't know, DJ Jones.
G
D
Jones knows
Jones.
all about nuclear stuff, so
Yeah. Does might
they
know
might
about
know
this
about
no
that
might
too.
know about the slides or lack
Exactly.
thereof. Yeah.
Yeah. There's Molly Mounds. Molly Mounds was totally worth it because she's
Oh.
still in love with him. Ooh. The space plane accelerating 10 G's landed at Kennedy Space Center.
Like jumping out and getting a great big whiff of hydrazine.
Oh my God, I mean, what else was everybody going to do? They were going to die in, like, what, an hour at this point?
Oh, Elite Geek stumbled in my channel blacklist. Sorry. Oh, we did it! We made it!
Oh, wait, but we had the wedding scene. And
oh,
the,
right.
We have the terrible scene.
Wedding scene.
It's not terrible. Why is it terrible?
All right.
I mean, weddings are pretty boring. But
stop and listen. Just listen.
Forever. We have the pictures of the people who died, including Gruber, who nobody cared about. I don't want to fall asleep because I miss you, baby. I don't want to miss you, baby.
Have a little more wine, Nicole.
You'll never hear me sing again.
No, it is the Gladstone's Brewery, which is one of our local breweries here in Courtney. It's their stout. Maybe it's their porter. I forget. Hard to tell the difference.
Be with you right here with you. Just like this.
Oh,
I'm pretty sure Tim's gonna break up with me now.
Oh. Oh, there we go. I just switched to. Are we gonna keep watching it?
Netflix? No, Netflix is trying to get me to watch something else now.
Yeah. What does Netflix want you to watch?
Chelsea.
Some of All Fears.
I don't know what either of those things are.
I'm gonna.
Because I miss you, baby.
Oh, did they get the science right for the wedding? Asked Michael Meyer.
I don't know how wedding science works. I know, yeah. All I know is when there's an open bar, it goes well. And not too many family members that all hate each other.
You can listen on YouTube forever.
Oh my God. Tim's back. Tim is literally back. My boyfriend's now in the chat.
Where
is
he?
I'm packing my suitcase now.
Yeah, my wife was in the chat earlier, but I won't tell you who it was.
Oh my God.
That was fun. Should we do this again sometime?
I think we should do this again. Let me do one more plug for the Do-It-Yourself Science Zone. So this was part of a fundraiser for the Do-It-Yourself Science Zone at Geek Girl Con in Seattle this weekend. We are raising money to get hands-on science demos in the hands of kids and adults. Adults are welcome too. At Geek Girl Con in Seattle. It's a 2-day con happening October 8th and 9th. We have a bunch of scientists meeting with kids and doing science activities with them. I will be doing Make Your Own Comet. I will be with Meredith Rawls. We'll be doing a comet you can take home. You can make out of craft supplies like tinfoil and paper and streamers and all that fun stuff. But I will also, we'll have some local peeps picking up dry ice for us so we can do some realistic comet models for people as well.
That's classic Nicole. That's your go-to move. Build a comet.
Classic Nicole. If somebody brings me dry ice and I make comets.
Yeah, you make comets out of them.
So this is the fundraiser. What we're doing as part of this fundraiser is as we reach different levels, we're doing acts of whimsy, which are silly things that don't cost us money because we don't have a lot of money personally, like live stream our reactions to Armageddon. At $6,000, we will do a funny music video, all of us who are at the con. That's the goal we're looking to reach. At $5,750, I will wear my full Holtzman costume to class and teach my modern physics class and send you guys pictures of that. I forgot what the other levels are. There's a whole bunch of people doing some fun things. Matthew Francis is involved in this, Dr. Matthew Francis, Dr. Rachel Burks, who's a chemist. She runs the Do-It-Yourself Science Zone. We're all doing these freaking ridiculous things to try and get you to donate money to have people do science. So thanks for that.
Awesome. Thanks for inviting me to share this madness with you, Nicole. It was always a pleasure to hang out with you. What fun.
I agree with folks that we should do this again.
We should probably do this again sometime.
Yes, I think we should get more of our weekly space hangout folks to help us pick apart.
Or the funniest people we can find.
Or the funniest people we can find, yes. Because We're not that funny. I'm sure watching me try and sing is hilarious.
That was pretty funny. All right. Well, I think I'm going to shut down the live stream. I'm going to stop the recording, and I'm going to say goodbye. But thanks, everyone, for watching. It wasn't Michael Dorn. I saw him from a different perspective. It was. It just looked like him from the side. that was super fun. All right. I'm going to stop
Thank
the
you, everyone, for watching with us and sticking with us in the chat. And,
And if this is something you want us to do again, we'll probably do something like this again. All right.
Thanks, Fraser. Have a good night, everybody.